So when we come up,
right now,
when we come up, there's going to be a few minutes, and then we're going to show the first commercial.
And it's just going to be 2 minute commercials from Awesome Show.
No, it's like the stuff we were paid to the branded content that we made.
Oh, but okay. Why wouldn't people just go on YouTube and look at that there?
We're going to watch along with them, and they're going to show us. We're going to tell stories, and hopefully these will entertain us as well, okay. So people will be able to see how we enjoy our own work.
Okay.
And this is what I put in the email, which is why I asked you to read the email before you came over.
Why I skimmed. But I'm here now, so let's have a good show.
All right, let's get the lights. Hi, everybody.
Hey, Eric Wareheim here, brand ambassadors for timanderic.com.
And I'm Tim Heidecker. I'm Tim Heidecker, and we are live with no technical difficulties.
Nothing. It's a beautiful transition. Is that on? We're so happy that you all joined us here.
We have Happy New Year. Eric, can you want to explain what we're having for?
Yes, this is it's a tradition for Tim and Eric watch-alongs that we drink bourbon, rye, and I did an audience poll today between two different whiskeys that look like shitty whiskeys. Even you were like, "What's the deal with this?"
Well, let's show the bottle. Can we show the bottle? We don't have an endorsement with this particular brand.
No, it's just kind of cool. A man named Clark Baker, who was a producer on Awesome Show and some of our commercials, gave me this as a present, Bourbon Deluxe.
It looks like something you'd find at a bad, like a dive bar in the Well.
Yes.
It looks like shit.
Or at like a Kmart, or if Kmart sold liquor back in the day, something shitty. But there was an era of time when they actually made good whiskey. And that's what this is, and I wanted to share it with you because this is a great new watch along in a new year.
It's a fine bottle. And what we're going to do is... We are going to...
And I'm drinking vodka in this one.
Okay.
So it's part of my New Year spritz.
In the VIP, you branded a new way of talking about the new year.
Yes, I did. It was pretty hot in the VIP. I said 2020 douche.
2020
douche. 2020 deuce. It turned into douche, but I think it should be Happy New Year. It's 2020 deuce.
I like as from a humor perspective, but not, I hope that doesn't catch on.
I hope honestly. It's not in big media, but maybe in our smaller circles, this group.
In the grunge community.
In the grunge community, yeah.
There's a lot to get through. There's a lot of material.
Yes.
And not all of it is great.
Yeah.
You know, we're not proud of it all. It is part of our history.
It really is. It is
who we are.
We thought, what would be a really cool watch along in 2020 deuce? And I've always made commercials and as friends.
Since you're a little baby.
We did it. We made diaper
commercials. He was in the diaper. You were in a lot of diaper commercials.
Yeah.
Big boy diapers.
Yeah.
See that you've seen it, but the audience has never seen Big Boy Diapers.
Yeah, it was kind of like it was like a husky section for big boys with big booty boys, and my booty was humongous as a child.
Big ass.
Yeah, so my parents got me in the biz, and they would ask me to save him so he would do the douche. The douche is on camera.
We used to make fun of commercials. Back in the very, very early days of Tim and Eric, I was looking for this, couldn't find it anywhere. Maybe you guys have seen it or know where we can find it. But we used to make up these jingles. We put these jingles on our website that we didn't have. Obviously, we weren't being paid by these companies to do.
Yeah.
We had H&R Block,
H&R Block, H&R Block, H&R Block, The reason we can't find them is because they were on timanderic.com, and this was before YouTube. Instagram, and they're somewhere.
We had When I Find Myself in Times of trouble, Radio Shack.
We got that's KFC. That's chicken for me.
And Celebrex, 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 Celebrex. What is what was Celebrex?
I think it was...
It was an antidepressant?
Yeah. Celebrate your new happiness.
So we were always interested in that, and we loved making fun of that stuff.
Yeah.
And one of the... Obviously, one of the brands we loved making fun of early on was the disgraced Papa John.
Papa John.
So let's kick it off with an early Tim and Eric Night Live episode moment.
Yeah.
Where we were doing a product placement for Papa John's. Again,
how far back are we? 2007 here. Yeah.
So we obviously were doing this live streaming Super Deluxe show, original version of Super Deluxe. While we were making Awesome Show, we made this show, Tim and Eric Night Live, where we would basically put on a live talk show with all our weirdo friends and people like Will Forte and Zach Galifianakis and Fred Armisen and Bob Odenkirk. Would come down, and it was a big old mess.
It was a mess. And we would also shoot this after a day of shooting sketches.
Right.
You know, but we put equal importance on it because we loved Night Live.
Again, this is our first commercial for Papa John's, and no financial transaction occurred between us and Papa John's for this. Right now, I want to kick it over to my friend Eric Wareheim, who's got a special message.
Not much
Papa
has changed.
Hi, my name is Eric Wareheim, and I know what you're saying. I hate ordering a pizza from Pizza Hut or Domino's because it's a dry, crusty cheese pie. But what you get at Papa John's is dips. And we made a little video celebrating the wonders of Papa John's, papajohns.com, and the different dips.
Okay.
Okay. He doesn't want to play it.
Okay.
That set was just like a
and you know, I think what's important about this video is that there's a lot of heart
vamp here.
And it took us a little too tall, could have used a few pounds. Tight pants points hollering out, working on our night moves, trying to make some front page driving moves,
working
on our night moves. Oh, that's gonna come back as a concept later, isn't it? Continuity to the work.
Lots of dip.
And a sweet.
Oh, no.
Why'd you do what? No. See, now
that
might have been
a
switcheroo. That's
that was a quick switcheroo.
Classic comedy.
Well, there you go. What? Papa John's pizza. We paused.
Oh, well, I don't know what that was. So that's how, that's the kind of the way we approached ads back then.
Yeah. We took that on the road. One of our first Tim and Eric tours, we did the whole Papa John's bit. We threw out pizzas.
What was the bit besides throwing pizzas into the audience?
I think it might have just been that. Just like us shouting Papa John's. We love Papa John's. We love the dippers. And people were like, why would you do that?
It must have been something else.
There had to have been.
We had the outfit. We had khakis and.
I did stage. I remember I stage dove too at one of our concerts.
I feel bad for that front row. No,
it was, I remember seeing some of the people being like, "It's a little large for this." Like cool, but like it's a little much.
Yeah, dangerous. So around the same time, we were starting. It was a little earlier. I don't know when this was, but we were making Awesome Show and. A movie called Shrek the Third was coming out.
Yeah.
It was the big trilogy for Shrek. And we had the idea that we would start doing our own viral marketing campaign for the Shrek movie. Because at the time, you couldn't get away from a billboard of Shrek. It was everywhere.
It was, it was disgusting.
Bus. It was,
We were inundated with it. You know, like people were coming out of McDonald's with Shrek sodas. It was Shrek everywhere. Shrek did not need two alt comedians to do viral campaign for them.
Grassroots stuff. Grassroots.
There's no need for that. And for us, that was everything.
We we do now, we had a green screen, a little studio, not much bigger than this. It's all coming back. It's all full circle.
Yeah.
We made these commercials for Shrek. So I haven't seen these since, I don't know, since my wedding. At my wedding, we showed these at my wedding.
That was beautiful.
The wait is over.
That's right. Shrek 3 is coming out May 18th, and we couldn't be more excited.
You know, gather up all your friends, go to your local theater, and check out this wonderful movie.
They're all back. You got Mike Myers, Cameron Diaz, Eddie Murphy, even Justin Timberlake's in the new one.
You know, go on the internet, post a bulletin, go on the message board, tell your friends about Shrek 3.
Looking guys. And check out our MySpace page, because we've redesigned it to look awesome. It looks like Shrek. It's really cool. And don't forget, the movie's coming out May 18th. Everyone go out and check it out.
Hi, this is Tim Heidecker. You know, we have a little tradition in our family. Whenever a Shrek movie comes out, the whole family gets together and we go out to the movie theater and have a great time. So May 18th is an exciting day for our family because Shrek 3 is coming out. And once again, we're going to sit in the theater, get ourselves some popcorn, and have a great time watching the voices of Mike Myers, Eddie Murphy, Cameron Diaz, and Justin Timberlake share their story. It's great for the whole family. It's great for kids. It's great for adults. Tim Heidecker saying, go check out.
He seems a little dim. Yeah. Seems a little dim.
But that is pretty strange.
Hey, this is Eric Ware with a personal message to all of our fans.
Yeah, this is huge.
Go out and check out Shrek 3 on May 18th. It is a wonderful animated film. It's got Eddie Murphy. It's got Justin Timberlake. This one's going to knock your socks off. So if you're a fan of Shrek 1 or Shrek 2, you're going to be blown away.
The wait is over. Hi, my name is David Hart, Lee the Hart, and you should see that new movie, Threat. It is marvelous. I have a crush on his beautiful green wife.
We were doing an awesome show by now.
Yes. There.
And it's on May the 18th.
Congratulations, Chris. You did it.
Direct message to the director here.
Hey, everybody. It's Tim Heidecker coming to you from Shrek.com headquarters, where I got a chance to meet up with some of the people responsible for Shrek.com, the website that was made exclusively for
so
the
by
film
now
Shrek
we have,
3.
This is like day two or three of making
this
new Shrek
promos. This is just one of the best websites
the
I've seen.
Changing.
And it has information
every
all
night
about
we go to bed thinking about Shrek ideas.
Film Shrek 3.
Consumed
as
us.
Well as the trailer for the movie, information on the characters, interviews with Mike Myers, Eddie Murphy, and all the rest. And I got to tell you, it's one of the best sites I've seen in a long time. Go check it out. Shrek.
About the website for Shrek.
Shrek 3 coming to theaters May 18th. This Friday, I'm going to be there. I hope you will be there, too. It's so clean, too. The picture is so clear.
It's great.
Oh, I love to see what phone
oh, is. I'm sorry. Tim and I are just checking out the third clips on my mobile phone.
Yeah, and it's cool. If you're a member of Singular or even, I believe, Verizon, you can get exclusive downloadable clips from Shrek the Third, which is coming to theaters May 18th.
You know, it's a great idea to get a trailer or just a preview or maybe even an interview from the director to see how the film's going on your mobile phone.
What I like to do is I can download wallpapers and make that my screensaver on my cellular phone or my PDA.
And usually right after the clip, there's a button you can push that will hot link you right to moviephone.com where you can buy your Shrek the Third tickets.
That's great. If you go to moviephone.com, you can put in Shrek, and you can find out where that movie's playing around you and what times it's playing at, which is really helpful.
Okay.
Oh, my God. Oh.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is James Quall to remind you that May 18th, there will be the picture entitled Shrek, so... What Shrek himself would probably say is, "What up, you know, be coming down
an extreme
to see in the picture."
For S-Day.
This was a big, I feel like there was a big collaboration with Ben Berman on this.
Yeah,
Ben
he was way into
to go
it.
In the movie theater and
kind
see
of
Shrek
editing
3.
And shooting
it's
it.
It's all come down to this. We want to thank Ford for making this movie possible. Everybody that made it, Disney.
Shrek.com, Expedia.net. Google.com, thank you so much.
And I haven't seen this kind of activity in 100 years.
Donkey.
There's grandmas. Everyone's here. We did it. Thank you, Google.
And we're going to be late. We got to get some popcorn. We're going to have a blast. This place is electric.
I don't think we actually went to see this.
No. I think we just walked out. We shot this in the studio. Just wait.
God.
This is the arc light, right?
The new characters were so funny. There were so many different voices that I recognized from other shows.
You know, I was thinking the same thing. It was that, you know? Is that Kelsey Grammer?
Is that Kelsey Grammer in this movie? Because I only remember him from Cheers and all the funny.
I want to thank Singular Wireless for allowing me to access Shrek.com right from my mobile phone and get insider tidbits on the director, Chris Miller. We want to thank you all for making this a huge event, making this a wonderful opening night. I mean, this
no one talks about the director
for cartoon. MoviePhone.com for making us the number one download on MoviePhone.com this week, and that's including mobile downloads.
What?
It was one of the best movies I've seen all year, probably all year.
Go ahead, check out Expedia.com.
All right.
Wow.
Wow, okay. So.
So much content.
Very, pretty wild.
Yeah.
I just see, like, not to name names or anything, but I see, like, a whole style of comedy that is still happening. That's some Big Bang version of, I think.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Do you want to call it out?
No. So no money. No, Shrek wasn't involved in that in any way. They were probably a little confused about what was going on. The people behind that movie.
We talked about it in the VIP, but we had a friend that was working with them, maybe a writer or something, and they did see it. But they did had no. They were like, "You guys, no one's even watching this. We're not going to shut it down. We don't care."
Yeah.
Well, we loved it. We were obsessed with making these things. We were also shooting a sketch show, and at night
there
we
must
do this.
Also, there must have been early on fans who were like, "Dude, you guys are gross. You've sold out."
They were.
But yeah, we were just doing it for laughs.
Yeah.
But then I don't know how this first. We're going to show a real commercial we made early. I don't know how this we got approached somehow by somebody if we would direct this commercial, and it was this is one I don't know if people know we directed because it's not something we would ever.
Before we were represented by Pretty Bird.
Yes.
This was just.
It was a cold call.
Okay.
And it was is Boost Mobile still a thing? I think it is. Cell phone service. Yeah. But they had an idea to do a parody of the 1985 or 80s, whatever, Super Bowl Shuffle with the Chicago Bears.
Which was a great
We spot. Loved that. We grew up loving that rap video. And if we went out to Chicago, they had assembled all the old Chicago Bears. And a little should I tell the story now or after we watch it? I think now.
Ditka story?
Well, there's two. One was, we had never done a real commercial before.
No.
And so they...
We've only done Shrek spots by
Shrek
ourselves.
Spots.
And Papa John's.
And some, you know, awesome show. But we, when you make a commercial, you are mostly dealing with the advertising agency. And so we had been talking to them and sort of, you know, the general idea is that it's going to be almost like a shot-for-shot remake of that music video with some gags put in, but the real joke of it is that it's almost like, you know, the exact same thing, except these guys are now 20 years old, 30 years older.
I think the look they wanted to be kind of vintage too.
Exactly. Like it was like, can we get the same cameras, the whole deal? And so all that planning was going on and we actually ended up shooting at the same place they shot the original one. And all this planning is happening. And there's the meeting, there's like the final production meeting that happens before the shoot, which is the next day. And somebody from Boost Mobile, who's paying for the ad, who's the client, says, after we walk through the whole shebang about how we're going to approach it and what's the plan for tomorrow. It's really the last time everyone meets and you kind of walk through.
Yeah.
There's really not much to go over except because
the decisions have been made.
And this woman says... I just have a question, like, what's going to be funny about this? Like, what's funny about this?
In all seriousness.
Yeah.
And also, just to set this up even more, like, we were a little nervous here. Like, we've never presented to a bunch of people that were outside of Adult Swim or our university. Yeah. Like, just...
And it was very uncomfortable because, you know, you will be the judge if she was in the right.
Yeah.
I don't know. But it was also not the time to ask that question.
Yeah.
Like, that's when you're supposed to be... You know, pitching this idea originally, and like we did our best to explain, like we think it's going to be funny and it's cool, but let's watch the Super Bowl and then we'll watch more.
It's Take a look.
And by the way, if you guys have questions, we'll take a little time. If you want to write questions in the chat,
yeah.
Matt is here.
Yeah, there's a Q&A button.
Q&A button. Matt's moderating it. If he sees something good, he'll let us know. We'll keep watching along.
Here it is, Boost.
I don't know why they need all this.
No. Maybe they have that.
With no association of Tim and Eric. Did Davin do this? I think Davin had to do this.
Yeah.
We are the Boost, shuffle and groove, still thrusting our hips, is that wrong to you? We're not here to make
things happen. Oh, there's my chick, huh?
We just here to do the Boost bubble shuffle.
My name's McMahon, and I'll tell you what's wrong. My tight end in a cheetah print thong.
Yeah.
That's fresh. Had cell phone last night to you all day long.
I'm the punter. The name is Mari. Getting better mobile is part of the story. The other part is cowbell playing, which I'll keep doing just as long as you're paying.
We are the Boost, shuffling crew. Still thrusting our hips. Is that wrong to you? We didn't come to either think or shake a rifle. We're just here to do the Boost mobile shuffle.
Doesn't look like a lot of those guys want to be there.
Yeah.
I'm Speedy Willie. I can still catch a pass. I also enjoy eating some bass.
Eating some bass?
But at the end of the day, what I think is nice?
What?
A dependable nationwide network at an honest price.
Well, how did he get that?
That's maybe the only imprint of our work is right there in the cowbell.
Yeah.
We like the cutaways. Too.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's not bad.
My mama's black oldest and I still could play if my groin didn't feel like paper mache. But it does. It ain't getting any better. Aging as well as one of
the. We had to record these guys in a recording studio for to do the. To,
yeah, and they were not. It's not that easy to do.
This is rough. I'll be honest with you. This is pretty rough.
Day long.
But it is what it is, like I said.
So let's change it up and do things right. Let's get Boost Mobile and go hot tubbing tonight.
Okay.
That's not
that's
bad.
Okay.
We didn't come here looking for trouble.
Those are rare and delicious.
Not bad.
Everything else bad. With the money you save, get a decent spray tan.
A lot of meetings about that.
Yeah. He's on green screen.
Right, and they couldn't. Oh. The fridge couldn't travel.
Yeah. He had some issues.
Medical issues.
Yeah.
Okay. We did our best.
That was
like 2 minutes.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's watch it again, Matt.
Oh my god.
Oh wow.
This must be like how the original one.
I don't think our names are associated with this in any way.
No.
Should have kept that secret.
Yeah.
All right. Well,
there you go.
We got that out of the way. But we start, you know, we learn, we grow, we evolve, we make better choices. And I think you'll see as we go through this, we want to show the difference between when Tim and Eric have free reign versus the hired gun job.
Tied down. Yeah, I mean, that was, again, this is the first time we're working with an agency that writes these bits that come to us. And
they've got jokes about waffles and ham, and you're just like, okay, I'll...
Like, why?
Yeah. Why?
Okay, we'll shoot it.
Anyways,
a lot. Yeah.
Dark energy here right now, folks. Any questions, Matt?
Yeah, we could take a question. Wait, I had a good one here. Where did it go? Sorry.
Was the place that we shot at the Metro?
A lot of people are asking questions along these lines. And Francesca Penny asks, what company would you love to do an ad for?
Ford.
Has to be Ford.
Mm-hmm. Harrison just Ford.
A Mustang. Ford Industries.
All right.
It doesn't really matter.
Yeah, you give us anything, as you'll see. Give us a pizza roll. We'll make something out of it.
If something comes to us during this experience, we will bring it up. But then something wonderful happened.
Yes.
Our friend, he had been on the show a few times, Zach Galifianakis, was approached by Absolute Vodka to make a little, they were going to give him a little bit of money to make something. He said, well, if I don't really have anybody to make this with, if I get Tim and Eric to do it, could you give us a little more money? And that's how this started. And there was no real, there might have been some word or something given to us, some like better together, or something about like friendship.
Yeah, something, spending time together.
Spending
maybe?
Time together. That might have been what they were looking for.
Yeah.
And we set up this scenario with the condition that you see the product, and that was kind of it.
Yeah. Yeah, and there was a history of these, like Absolute and whatever ad agency they were working with at the time. No offense, because these guys were great because they brought us on. But they Spikes Jones made like a film, and like Kanye West made a film with Absolute. So we were like, this is kind of cool. Maybe we could flex a little bit and do our thing without too many notes or anything. And because we had Zach, I think they gave us a couple rules. We had to learn a little bit about alcohol advertising, what you can do and can't do.
We didn't abide by
that. We did not.
And then that's kind of why it just kind of ended up on the internet.
Yeah.
And nowhere else. Like, Absolute had to kind of say, we can't really put this out on our own.
Yeah.
It has to come out from you guys. But let's see it. I haven't seen it. By the way, the quality on this one's a little low, but that's just because of the times. You'd make something and put it on YouTube at like 480p or something.
Yeah. At the time, it was like on my YouTube at 480p. And who knows?
But treat it like you're watching an old Charlie Chaplin film or something. We'll get Peter Jackson to restore it one day.
The way that she looked at you.
Looks fine.
Said that joke. It's vamping here.
Look at Zach and
I know. Well, I tell you, it works every time.
I was crying.
Tell you, it's the most relaxing day of the year.
Guys,
very Floridian.
And some Absolute and ice.
Oh, cheers.
That's nice. Tiny chair.
Really wonderful, Zach. Thank you.
Wow, hit the spot.
A little.
What is this, ice?
Absolute on ice.
Ah.
What's this, ice?
Really strange wigs. Yeah.
Zach would go and pick up his own wig before each shoot. Part of his process, we would just have to adapt. But absolutely, like.
Everything.
It's a hell of a hot tub you have out there.
Oh, thank you.
Keeps a little bit too hot for my blood, you know.
I got a lot of legs showing.
Yeah.
It is a bit hot.
Well, then I say we toast to cooling off.
Oh my god.
Cooling off. Because there's cubes in here.
That's me really laughing.
Yeah, I know.
What's gonna cool us off? Okay, hello, drink we're drinking. Knock knock.
It's really good.
I don't think it's a joke. I don't think it's funny.
Classic zoom-ins.
It's not funny!
Okay.
Don't talk! The hot tub's too hot! I flew down here for the seventh time! I'm not coming down anymore!
Okay, Zach.
I'm not gonna fly down here anymore!
Come, this should be just a fun time between us.
It's not fun when it's so hot! The hot tub's too hot. I've told you about this before. It's just too hot.
I have an abbreviated disc, okay? I've got to sit in that tub at 111 degrees for at least 8 minutes a day, okay? I'm sorry.
It's not just about the hot tub, though, is it, Zach?
Look at those wigs. It's so shitty.
You like the color of your mini golf ball.
It's the hot dogs are too small, not enough ketchup.
You thought the rides weren't scary enough.
The wave runners were too slow.
Come on, it's an epidemic.
Your chair was too big, so we got you this small one, and you're not even happy with that.
I put all this wicker up just for you.
I'm sorry, guys. Both of my parents died a couple hours ago.
let's have another drink.
All right.
Let's forget about it. Okay? I'll put some ice in the hot tub. We'll all get in there. We'll have ourselves a good time.
Okay.
I can't believe Absolute Vodka didn't win a line of both my parents died a couple hours ago.
Oh. A little more.
That's a good gag.
Oh.
A little tube.
Yeah. It's a mess.
Now everything else we shot would have been us laughing.
Yeah,
because that's all we did on that stupid 2 hours. We just shot and laughed, silly Zach, me and you, laughed and laughed, and we're like, we're not gonna be able to use any of this.
You can see a lot of our eyes were crying. It's like from laughter. And we couldn't, we also don't look at each other a lot because I think we were cracking each other so much. There's a lot of stuff we just play out to the cameras.
I would love I'm sure that doesn't exist, but the outtakes of that would be, that's the whole
thing. That would be amazing.
So that we have a couple more, right?
Yeah.
You know, I switched to pure canola oil.
Oh, yeah, I can smell.
It actually works better.
Our voices are so higher pitched.
You know what I do is I just melt down a six-pack of chapstick, get it over me, and you get that cherry smell. There he is.
Hey, Zach.
Hey, guys. Sorry, I was out of giant olives. Absolute on the rocks.
Give me.
Thank you, sir.
Mm. Look at these.
This is real nice.
Horrible chairs. Oh, my God.
Cheers. Cheers to fun in the sun, guys.
Yeah. This bathing suit.
Chen.
Those are some, those are like the hangover sunglasses.
Yeah.
Just soaking the rays.
Those are his, yeah.
Great day.
It's a heck of a day. I was thinking tonight for dinner we should go to Michael's again. I hope 2 days in a row isn't too much.
It'd be 4 days.
Get the red snapper this time, it's delicious. Trust us.
What you do is you get the scallops appetizer, blackened, and for dessert you can either get the creme brulee or the hot chocolate fudge sundae.
Hot fudge sundae.
Hot fudge sundae for me too. You gotta try to warm it up.
That's exactly what I ordered last night.
Okay.
Maybe you should pay attention.
He's so frustrated.
To what your friend is ordering. Yeah. Make another conversation mistake.
Suggesting the same place.
We were with him, but.
I got it, guys.
We didn't see what he got.
Let's take a dip in the ocean.
Now you're talking. Here we go. Really cool off. I'm just gonna.
There's a lot of this business in our early work.
A lot of groins.
Not being able to do normal things like stand up.
A roll.
Oh, yeah.
Jump cutting that.
I think I was pregnant at the time.
There it is.
Come on, Zach.
Come on.
Zach, it'll be fun. Come on. Let's go.
Beehive.
You up. Let's get in the water.
Come on. Get wet.
I have body image issues.
Come on, you're with friends.
Good guy in the back.
Yeah.
Zach, come on. Damn it,
drama.
Come on.
It's a penis joke.
Yeah.
This isn't anymore.
I feel uneasy about this.
Come on,
you'll
be great.
You know what? No, I don't want to do it. I don't want to do this.
This is stressful.
Yeah.
I don't want to be dragged into the ocean.
No.
This is a good punch here.
Yeah.
Stop! I'm tired of this!
Oh. This one.
Stop!
That's a good punch.
Texas.
This is it!
Oh. Get them down. Everyone's grabbing their wigs. Make sure the wigs don't fall.
It's good combat.
Yeah. Let's go to a beach party.
Okay. Socked us both twice in the mouth.
We deserved it.
It's really psychotic.
This is our way. This is how we party. There's the wing.
Oh no.
That's high end special effects.
Oh, this is gross. I think this is not a special effect. I think you just went for it here. Yeah. You just went for
it.
Yeah. Wow.
Wow. That one got me. The fight scene's so good.
All right, last one. Oh, I love this.
Yeah.
Great outfit here. There's a whole story developing.
I'm not coming down anymore.
Relationships.
I can't just lie down here anymore. The hot tub's too hot. Too hot. Too hot.
Keep it cool tonight, Zach. They're your best friends.
No, but you know, I said to the bartender, better make it a double because these two are hot. Exactly.
Come on in.
Come on in.
Oh no. This can't be good.
I would like to introduce you to
Tetris. Tetris.
And this is Jenga.
What do you hear Tetris singing voice?
This is
Gail again. Singing voice.
And Jenga is a ballroom dancer. Check it out.
Ooh. Yeah. Me like.
Ooh la la, wet fox.
But Jenga's yours and Tetris is mine.
Who are these floozies?
They're our friends. We just met them at the barnacle.
So we come back here and have a little bit of jade au toit. You know what I mean?
I didn't make enough cookies for five. I made cookies for three. There's not enough room at the breakfast nook.
Why don't you two give Zach a little hello kiss and maybe he'll change his opinion of you.
Go ahead, Jenga. Give him a kiss.
No.
Go on, Zach. Open up. There he goes.
Twitches.
Go, one more, girl.
No!
Stop!
No!
One,
two, three, four.
No!
Different.
Yeah. Trim wit. Your way. It's like a ball.
Stop.
Girls, would you mind waiting by the
baking gloves on?
Get to the jet skis, girls.
Jet skis.
Damn it.
Don't sit on them.
Zach, listen. We totally forgot about your snack function. We're really sorry for bringing over these hussies.
I feel like a total jerk.
Accept our apologies, please. We'd love to have your cookies.
No problem. I've been trying to work better on my temper, and I think I really, that was good. That
to me, you nailed it.
You went here, but you didn't go up here. It was really nice.
I've really working on it. The girls were nice. I mean, she was an excellent singer. And your friend, a really good dancer. Whoa, there's moves.
After you, Mifflaw.
Thank you.
I personalized them.
Do you have any vodka to go with this? It would be perfect.
Yeah, do you guys like Absolut? Because I have some of that.
Oh my god.
I said I don't think we should overtly make fun of the product while we're doing this. You know, kind of be a little more subtle. I think when you're doing that, it's going to sort of send the wrong message.
Cheers to you guys. Last night.
Yeah.
I don't think Zach knew that was coming.
That's good stuff. Subtle
stuff, isn't
it? Tiny glasses.
That's
too much.
What are you talking about?
No. Hey, come on, stop. We're not going to use that. Do we have another one of these?
Fully breaking.
Yeah.
It's one thing to do the dance and stuff about vodka, but when you actually kind of mess up the product, I think it goes too far. It's what are we really saying with that?
But I think that maybe
I just think if we're going to focus so much on the cake stuff or the cookie stuff, but don't, come on, let's try to have a conversation here. It's a waste of time.
Look at me, I barely keep it together.
Tim, come on. We gotta finish this. Zach's gonna do whatever he wants on every take, no matter what.
I'm sorry, guys.
Let's just move on.
How do you move on from that?
I don't know. We'll fix it in post. Ben?
There's Ben.
Burn the van.
Good. Hey, get it out of your system, because then we'll reset and do it again.
Wow. I like this
community. Yeah.
And your notes, again, are just
your notes.
A little bit more subtle type stuff?
Can I make a suggestion? I think we should lose our wigs. We'll just do a straight look in the camera and say,
eyebrows.
Hi, I'm Zach Galifianakis. Hi, I'm Tim Heidecker. Hi, I'm Eric Wareheim. Won't you buy vodka, buy Absolut Vodka? Just do a freaking ad, you know? Just do an advertisement for the alcohol, for the vodka. It's what I wanted to do from the beginning. You guys, I want to tell your little stories, prance around, but.
Which camera should I use? Ben's?
Who's directing? Is there anybody making a call? You want to do it with the wigs?
Hi. This isn't a wig, so I
understand
my natural hair. Hi. I'm actor Zach Galifianakis.
Yeah.
And I'm Tim Heidecker.
And I'm Eric Wareheim.
Let me go on record for Absolut Vodka and say that the product is wonderful. I've enjoyed drinking it immensely while working on these ads.
And I can say on behalf of myself, there's no better vodka on the market right now than Absolut Vodka.
Absolut Vodka, a delicious drink at a reasonable price. Cheers, guys.
We'll edit into it.
You can put a graphic in here. I'll have a martini with Absolut, please.
Now you're talking my language. Oh, that would be a good line.
Yeah. And then they
also, I'm not happy with it. I'm not happy.
Well, it was good working with you, and good luck
With your show.
Good luck with your shows and your movies and your career, your acting career.
Thanks so much for this opportunity, Zach. It's been a pleasure.
I don't want to walk off here feeling like, you know, we.
I'm laughing. Yeah. I have to be laughing.
Yeah.
Yep. Laughing. Yeah.
I'm biting my tongue. It's going to be like.
Someone call 911. We'll call 911 right now.
This is a slow movie.
Yeah.
Oh,
my God.
That's it right there.
The hit was it.
That's the hit.
You knew you got.
I shouldn't have done this. I don't know if we needed this.
The extra swizzle.
No, you're fine, but me pouring the bag over the head.
It's fine, though.
It's high
good.
Concept
yeah.
stuff.
Look at that.
Wow.
Wow.
I mean, that's like a Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf kind of thing. Very heavy.
You two were like, sometimes a big part of my role in this is just to like sit
Stay
back, like. Because you get to watching that, you two have something for each other. You're like,
yeah,
it's going to get to that place. I love it.
That was intense.
Yeah.
I mean, I know we must have talked about how that was going to go, but it did go into like, we went with it,
yeah.
But it wasn't, I'm sure that food fight stuff was not super planned out.
No, it was definitely not scripted anywhere. Yeah, it was like, if I can remember, that was, yeah, they let us make three of those films. Each time we would have a talk with them, and then said, "Hey, you guys still broke all the rules of
right.
alcohol
yeah,
advertising."
I don't know why they kept coming back.
Yeah, I think they just loved it. It was like a passion yeah. project. But we loved it too because it was, yeah, we loved working with Zach. We made this whole world. We then went on and made Bathroom Boys together.
Yeah,
and the movie—he was in $1 billion movie, kind of similar character, big wig.
Yeah, it's always the same
big
dynamic.
Wig. As long as he can go to his wig shop, comes in.
Couple chatters wanted to know, where was the beach shot?
Malibu, by
yeah
my house on the beach.
Private.
No, yeah, it was Malibu. I'm sure it was freezing. It's always
yeah.
freezing cold. If you ever see anything shot at the beach in California, it's going to be very cold.
Arctic.
The water's freezing, but I think it was must have been Malibu.
And they want to know how you met Zach.
I mean, Zach probably just came through Bob. He was like, before The Hangover, he was just a very funny comedian that we all thought was top notch.
Yeah.
very funny person.
We just see him live at like small.
Yeah.
It was amazing.
At Largo. And
what was the first thing he did with us?
I think he was on Tom Goes to the Mayor. As just one of the, he was like a
character. I can't remember that one.
I think he was like a doctor or something. You know.
Yeah.
Probably wasn't utilized that well. But yeah, that's how we met. Met at comedy college, clown school.
Yeah, we did have one idea. It was like a 10th anniversary or something.
We talked about it with him, but it never. We just never happened. Reunion.
Yeah. I was like, where do you go from there? Sometimes you just have to be like, that's the end of that.
I think, in fact, by the time we did Bathroom Boys, I think after that I saw him and he was like, I think we've played every move we can with those three guys. You know?
Yeah. Yeah, after breaking the fourth wall and doing flower play, just three men.
So here's another one that we were approached. I think this was a little bit of a hybrid. It was, we were approached by this video game. We're not gamers, so we don't really know this world. But they're like, we have this big budget for this huge ad campaign for this game called Saints Row. And I'm remembering not getting this at all. Like, I'm remembering not understanding this at all.
But the that video
there's like
game?
There's like a mini game within this other game. And they're like, we want to make a weird, fucked up, like middle, like, sort of a Japanese game show on acid kind of show based on this mini game in another game. Like, sure.
Yeah, that's exactly. In the VIP, we're talking about someone asked, do you guys ever try to make a video game? And we're like, we'd love to. We just don't understand the format enough to understand what this even is. What is the name of this? Is it Saint Row or is it Genki? But we were on board. Every now and then we checked our timanderic.com email. if you write to us like, hey, we don't have the email anymore. But these guys wrote to us. Same with, I think, a couple other things that we did. That was awesome.
It was pretty much like, you have free. How long is this one, Matt?
It's like 12 minutes.
It's a big one.
Yeah.
We want it to be this long movie, like an episode of something. And the challenge, I think, was when you do something that's so absurd and so ultimately like meaningless and crazy, it's hard to maybe like fill that. We did it, but it's hard to like write for insanity because it's like, I don't know. Anything can happen, so that kind of makes it harder, but we went full, like this was maybe the height of our like craziness.
Yeah.
Like, crazy was like all we cared about. Like, dark.
How
and
dark could we go? Yeah. This was also a huge budget for us. I remember this budget of this being bigger than our TV show. And we had all these tools. We got to hire all of our, like, we made these. It was all the people that we worked with on Awesome Show and Tom Goes to the Mayor. It was like our family that helped make everything, and we hired David O'Reilly, did this animation for it, and we cast a lot of these people, and so it was half like kind of a high production thing for us, but half just a very awesome show, as you'll see with some of the things that happen.
And again, two guys, Eric and I, don't really fundamentally understand what it is we're even making. It's an interesting thing, and we don't know what the product is. We don't know what they're trying to get across, except maybe just get people to watch something because it's so weird.
Yeah.
But it's pretty interesting, maybe. I haven't watched it.
Yeah, I haven't seen it in a while. Let's do it. Let's watch it together. Blood and gore. Sexual.
The following paid presentation is brought to you by Citizens for Saints Row III. In stores November 15th. Praise Genki. Welcome to Professor Genki's super ethical reality climb, brought to you by Five Star General Show's Five Step Two Star.
By the way, I think Greg wrote some of this stuff. We needed to fill.
Yeah.
This guy's such a good look.
Yeah. Yeah, sort of like a cult game show, prison, murder. All in one.
It's almost like a. What's that new show?
Love you all.
Crab game?
Squid game.
Squid game.
Can we welcome the great one onto our stage and begin the show? Quiet! Let us pray. O wonderful host of hosts, let us bask in the light of your presence. Let us feed on your cat breath and smell your power. Come unto us and allow us to show our
prayer. We loved this shit.
And the sacrifice of others. Ladies and gentlemen, Professor Genki.
I guess that was the character.
That was the character, yeah.
Upon your command, we can begin the games, Your Honor. Begin the game! Genki Girls!
Genki Girls. Oh my god, man.
I love that. Yeah. That's good editing.
Yeah. Did Eric Natarnicola do some of this?
I like, couldn't tell you.
Some of the graphics are great. Genki Girls.
Sure.
I love that graphic.
Rosso!
Rosso! That was migraine inducing.
Yeah.
This guy's good.
Yeah.
That's a great outfit.
So many characters.
I have had a chance to visit with the caged ones earlier, and I have to say, I think that Brozo the Troll
Brozo the
has
Troll.
Rounded up some terrific contestants for you, my lord. Genki, Professor Genki, Exalted One. Let's take a look at the big bird! Contestant 0551. Pick your category.
I think they have all lipstick all over.
Yeah.
Pick one.
Human
how
disgrace.
About shame on display?
Show me shame on display.
Oh, fuck.
Sorry about that.
I know we had to. We
if
didn't
you can
get to release.
Yourself by the end of
this
the show,
might
Professor
be amazing.
Genki will be very pleased. Let's begin the game. Eat yourself.
I think the idea of eating yourself is pretty fucked up. Oh, that's
definitely a Greg idea.
Yeah.
Oh my god, this is it. Holy shit. Holy shit.
Let us pause and remember the origins of our lord, Genki. It must be done!
Genki was a renowned professor of science at the
wow.
This is David
yeah.
O'Reilly, right?
Yeah. Scientist
taught who happened to be a cop. This is this may have been in the game or something, or the story is. I don't know.
Melt their two beings. I don't know.
I could never follow what the hell was going on.
I know. You're so checked out. You were like, I'll do Brozo stuff.
Eat yourself.
There had to be a script or something.
Yeah.
There had to be something written down for this.
Yeah, somebody, there had to have been a production meeting. Yeah. Discussion about this. With cat food and human brains. Oh, science. He became all powerful and supreme. Worshipped leader. This might be a little
wow.
bit of a controversial, you know, appropriation kind of thing. Nowadays.
Yeah.
The next challenge goes to contestant 0, 4, 5. Please pick your challenge.
A lot of controversial things about this.
Yeah.
A human disgrace.
Oh, she's good.
It's Rabbit Dog.
Oh no.
Oh no. This is a real nightmare.
Contestant, pay attention. You must capture the meat at the end.
I think Squid Game did steal this.
I think
from
so.
Us.
Have some competition. The rabbit dogs are ready to defend the
oh,
piece of
they're,
meat.
They're the dogs. That's a. There's truly nightmarish
yeah.
images going
yeah.
on here.
You are so lucky. It looks like the dogs are asleep. How long will that
the
last
dogs.
For, guys? Let's begin.
Pretty easy.
Uh-oh, they all come on.
Uh-oh.
girls.
Oh, too bad. I thought you had a chance at that meet, didn't you, gang? We shall return after this message.
Buy my video game.
Oh my God,
this is good.
Now! Yeah.
This is so good.
I love my Saints Row.
My Saints Row smells smart.
The resolution on this ding dong is sad.
I take a fork and scratch my Saints Row and it still works.
Saints Row.
Yo ho ho ho.
And a bottle of Saints Row.
Sad.
I did it because it looks like a bagel, but I choked.
Mama don't know I play Saints Row.
Saints Row, first yeah. Oh. Beyond, Mama.
Go say wee wee, I'm sexy playing Saints Row.
I am talented with games and Saints Row.
I'm talented.
Do a flip.
Saints Row.
I play Saints Row.
Oh my. Wow.
Another super climax.
There's a commercial
challenge
within this commercial.
Genki has wished for a tall cat parade.
Yeah. Cat parade. This was amazing.
They're just dogs.
Yeah. And they're not trained dogs. I remember our production people were like, they're not, none of them are trained. Like, they're just dogs. Like, all right, let's just walk them through.
All cat parade you have ever seen. A special guest in our next challenge. It's General Joe.
Oh no.
General Joe. Five-step, two-star chicken.
Five-step, two-star.
Yeah.
So
thank you for coming, General.
My honor to serve Janky.
Your chicken is so wonderful and fulfilling. Can you tell us about your new dry cooked chicken?
Yes, my new star chicken is
it's called General
Joe's brand new five-step two-star chicken. It's a full chicken that is frozen and vacuum sealed.
And when you open
there it is.
You simply breathe on the chicken, which thaws and cooks the chicken.
And is it true?
It is good, technically
rotten chicken.
Yes. My new chicken, my new grandson.
Well, fascinating. You are here today to help us with a special challenge
that involves
all three contestants. Your challenge will be to replicate a famous billing using only General Cho's famous two-star chicken and common household duct tape. Contestants, proceed to your chicken station.
Oh, God.
With Genki's kind permission, we can begin.
Wow.
And begin!
It is interesting to see my chickens used in this way.
Hurry up. And that's all the time we have. Now, my lord, if you would grace us with your choice of winner.
Oh my God.
Contestant 0456 wins! The two losers will be immediately destroyed with General Joe's automatic chicken gun, which Professor Genki will administer. Oh my lord, I love it when you shoot that chicken gun! There is one winner of this challenge. How does it feel to be so successful?
It's peaked for me.
Yeah.
Good.
Genki will now decide if you are to be released.
Compare it into Cho's.
Yeah.
Good shooting.
Oh, yes.
Oh, wow.
First Tennessee Luke appearance, maybe.
Tennessee, I'm so glad you're home, buddy. I have some amazing news.
What is that?
Samantha, she just woke up from the coma.
Okay.
the stupid doctors. They didn't think she'd make it. I knew she'd make it. It's been a real struggle. I feel truly...
Sounds interesting.
And it's been a struggle, but I've been by her side every day for a year now. So this morning, I got down on one knee and proposed to her right there in the hospital.
Oh, how romantic.
It was. She said yes.
Yes.
And then we held each other. We cried. And we thanked God that we'd be together forever.
Hold on. Let me try and picture that.
So, Tennessee, I have something to ask you.
Yes?
Will you be my best man?
I can't. I'll be busy playing Saints Row 3.
Wait, I haven't even told you the date yet.
Doesn't matter. I'll be playing them, too.
Is this some kind of joke?
Get out of my condo.
Mike, believe it's you.
There he is. Why not? They're probably filling time at that point. Oh, there we go.
Send inquiries regarding.
Oh my God! What? That's a real nightmare.
How long was that, Matt?
Like 12 minutes.
Jesus. Oh, that's amazing that that was made.
There's some very special moments in that. 2011. There's some very special moments in that. This could definitely use a chop down.
It could use a little trim. We could use a royalty check from Squid Game.
Yes.
It really inspired that. Probably not. Wow. I don't know about you guys, but I need a quick Tall Cat Parade break.
Yeah.
Yeah. We have one more. We have one more on the schedule before our schedule break. Do you want to get through that?
You want to take a question? What do you want? You could use a break. I'll hold it.
Let's keep to the schedule here.
Okay.
This and is, one question and one one.
A one video. And one.
We have one
and
one.
This is Russell Fowler. Do you have to hover over these commercial shoots? He's saying director, but I think he means is there somebody else getting all of the green screen shots, or do you have to like really get all the coverage? How in the weeds are you?
We're pretty in the thick of it for most of it. You know, like we're there for every shot almost.
Oh yeah. I mean, there's so much gold that happens in the edit room that we're not there for all the edits. We don't sit there and edit it ourselves. But, you know, by the time we're doing some of the stuff we're about to see after the break, it's been people that we've been working with for years, and there's a certain common ground and understanding. But the goal is always to, like, maximize the jokes at every step of the process. So
yeah, especially when we have one like this, or Absolute, or Totino's, where we wrote it, we're in it some of the times, and we're editing it with our team.
Yeah.
That's the best part, is when, I mean, there's so many edit jokes in that our team is so good at.
I don't know if, like, you'd look at the script and say that guy's on the head of a parrot.
Yeah.
That's probably just an editor being like, I don't know what to do with this.
It's not that funny.
I'm going to put him on a parrot and fly him around.
Yeah.
So we wanted to show one other thing before the break that is, I guess, a commercial in a way, because when we do a tour, we love to announce the tour with a video that should stand on its own as a funny piece of video. So this is one of our old, when we got a little tour to England, we played, I think, just basically Dublin and London.
Yeah.
But we treated it like it was a tour, and we made a little promo video.
Oh my God!
Guess what? I'm Eric Wareheim, and I got a big
fucking announcement.
Tim and Eric, awesome European tour. Great job. Just Islands 2011. We're doing London. We're doing Dublin. We got DJ.
That's it.
He's just coming to London, though.
Hi, I'm Tim Heidecker from comedy troupe Tim Eric, and we are also going to be in London and Dublin.
We took all the best comedy stuff troupe. That we do in America, we're bringing it over to Dublin and London. Log on to timanderic.com for tickets, you douche.
If you live in London or Dublin, you will get access to our shows if you have access to see the show.
Oh my God!
It's an 8-show tour. It's just Ireland. We're not doing Barcelona. We're not doing Milan. We ain't going to Sicily. Guess what, USA? We're not coming to you. We ain't going anywhere but Dublin.
We have four nights in Dublin?
Yeah, we did that small theater in the St. Charles.
My grandma was Irish, and she came from Cork.
And now here's Tim Heidecker doing 11 incredible British impressions in under 1 minute.
Hi, I'm Paul McCartney, and I'm on behalf of Tim and Eric coming down to see them in London. Hi, I'm Mike Kane. Hi, I'm King Charles. Hi, I'm the film comedian John Cleese. Hi, I'm rock singer Mick Jagger. Hi, I'm soccer player David Beckham. Hi, I'm rock drummer Beatle Ringo Starr. Hi, it's mate James Bond himself, Mr. Pierce Brosnan. Hi, this is Simon Cowell from America's Idol. Hi, Mike, this is CNN's Pierce Morgan. Hi, I'm piano player Elton John, reminding you that we are gonna, that Tim and Eric are gonna buy you to London this summer.
We're just doing Dublin. We're just doing London. What else do you want?
I can guarantee Tim and Eric are excited to be even in London, and that's a gift because of Queen. We were invited by the Queen, King.
I love our Prince William.
Oh, he's out of here, King.
All we know is kisses. Wow.
You gotta go back to Elton. All right, we'll take a piss break. I suggest you do the same.
Yeah. Reload. We'll be right back.
Right now, I want to kick it over to my friend Eric Ware.
Whiskey can my liver handle? Oh, not tonight. All I can think about is Mexican food and those chips.
I never get spicy salsa because we always have mild salsa because of the kids. And now, I always get talking about salsa with Tim Heidecker here talking about salsa with Eric Wareheim. How I don't really get to experience spicy salsa anymore because my kids. Sometimes at night we have a medium salsa here. It's nice.
But what must be nice is when you do get a little spice, some habanero, some serrano pepper. That is, it must make you feel even extra better because you don't usually have mild.
I've been accustomed to it. Now, second half of the program begins.
Yes.
We're going to start with, I think, another rough one. We were part of a comedy collective called Jash.
Jash.com.
Which is ultimately, I think, you know, there's successes in life and there's failures. I think ultimately Jash was... a failure, ultimately, but there was a period of time where we were making some stuff under that banner.
Yeah.
It was a noble idea.
Some great people involved.
And
the talent, just attitude. So, hey.
Yeah, that was what Jash stand for. That's the big...
Jash was going to be like JeffGoldblum.com at one point, wasn't it?
I don't remember. Yeah, maybe.
We had a Jash meeting, and Jeff Goldblum was there with his at-time girlfriend, and we were cracking up for like an hour.
Oh, we're at a dinner.
Yeah. We were trying to come up with a name. We're like, what if we just called it Jeff Goldblum? Yeah.
And it was a little before Jeff Goldblum was kind of like a meme.
Yeah.
A meme.
We do have some Jeff Goldblum content coming up.
But now, where
are we, Tim? Are we with, do we have an agency at this point?
Yes.
Or are we on our own?
We have an agency, but this came through Jash, because Jash worked with YouTube to produce a comedy award show or something. It was, nobody knew what this was.
Yeah, this was wild.
It was like a big, huge production. And it's called Comedy Week or something.
Yeah.
And they're like, you know, can you and Eric do a root some kind of sketch? And sometimes when we get asked to do something specific, it's very hard because then you have to sit and like actively think of ideas as opposed to an idea coming and then doing your best to do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
This was the opposite. This was like, you have to do something now. What is it? And somehow the idea of let's go out and do a Red Lobster endorsement, but almost like, you know, thinking we were doing Papa John's. It was like in the tradition of Papa John's. But I think the trap now was people thought we were shilling for Red Lobster.
Yeah.
But this was a case where we were not. So let's look at it. This was a live bit, which is also something, and it was not our crowd.
Yeah.
I haven't watched this. I bet it's not the best. But we'll see.
You guys be the judge. Hit us up in the chat after
Comedy Week.
Here we come. You can hear us already. There we go. Come on now. Subtle.
This is great. How many people out there are big Red Lobster fans, huh?
I have no recollection of being on stage at this at all.
You just can't get enough Red Lobster. Can you cut the music now, please?
Cut the music. When do you ever hear that in real life?
Cut the music. Stop the music.
Can you ever see that energy?
Stop the music! Come on, stop the fucking music!
We literally have lobsters.
Turn the music off.
I don't like that.
Well, thank you guys so much. So happy to be here, part of Comedy Week. What a great night it's been. How much fun has this been, huh?
It's totally awesome.
We're so rad.
Now, I bet a lot of you guys, shut up, hold on a second.
Shut up.
I bet a lot of you guys are wondering, what the hell, why are you guys so red? Why are you holding lobsters? Well, as you guys probably know, this week we celebrate 100 years of Red Lobster. 100 years.
I cannot believe how long it's been. And you know, growing up, every Friday I would go to Red Lobster with my family. And on my birthday, my step pepper would turn to me and say, son, why don't you upgrade to the surf and turf?
Oh!
Noah laughing.
Awesome. I knew this guy was a surf and turf freak. I knew it from the moment I met him.
Noah knows we're going to laugh for this.
Well, Eric, you're going to be so excited to find out that this week, Red Lobster is introducing, for the first time ever, they're calling it the Endless Summer All-You-Can-Eat Surf and Turf. How many people would love to sign that, huh?
A couple of
lose. Surf and turf just time for the real summer.
Oh my God.
I didn't realize the timing was so perfect.
Who writes this stuff?
Thank you so much.
You can feel the audience losing us.
We're losing the audience. About this endless summer surf and turf.
We really are. And you know, the good folks over at Red Lobster are going to blow the roof off of what you and I think turf really is.
That's right, because you know, we all get stuck in that paradigm where we think that turf means steak. You know, I love steak. No offense to steak.
Tim's a beef boy.
No.
If you're gonna go to a teleprompter, let me know. Well, no, but it's true though. They're gonna stop the way you think about what turf is. For example, if you don't want steak, you can get chicken, you can get pork. Hell, you can even get Chinese food.
Hold on. What if I'm in the mood for some succulent lob, and I also want some Italian pizza pie?
Well, it's whatever your heart desires, my old friend.
Oh my God. Tim, my desire right now is to have an intimate table for two of some of this endless summer surf and turf by Red Lobster right now.
Well, Eric, you're my friend, my partner in life, and I want to ask you to do yourself a little favor. Why don't you close your eyes and make a wish?
We have lobsters in your hands.
Eric, mine will take a look.
Oh, this is great. Let's eat.
I love the idea of endless surf and turf.
Thank you, Tim.
Oh, and by the way, guys, we've got a very special treat for you guys, too. Hit the music.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Black Eyed Peas, it's Fergie!
Oh my God.
It's not her.
Yeah.
I think it was the kind of thing where, like, if we realized that we could give them these ideas and they'd actually have to do all this stuff, right?
Yeah. We're just not even looking at her.
Of course, I'm going to start spitting food out.
You're eating with such conviction. He's eating so. Oh, God. Tiffany. The guys at the switch are like, who do I go to here? Steak.
Full band playing this song.
Thank you guys. Big round for Fergie, huh?
Ferg spinning.
Thank you guys so much.
Thank you from Red Lobster.
And anybody can help themselves to our leftovers. Good night, everybody.
Oh, everybody can help themselves. Oh, that worked out. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
So hateful. A lot of anger in that bit for some reason.
So much anger. Like, it was... Yeah, they had like a red carpet. There's like... We showed up in those red tuxedos. It was a whole thing.
Yeah. All right, let's keep the show going. With another promo for Bedtime Stories, I guess. This was like a sort of like the live tours.
Yeah.
We would do commercials for our shows.
Yeah, I mean, Adult Swim, when we made shows, we'd be like, we'll do all the advertising too. Yeah, like, let us do it. We were such like control freaks. They made their own ads about it, but we felt like we had to control every single second of it and make these freakish spots.
Three, two, one.
Trick or treat!
Hi, my name is Tim Heidecker, and I'm with Eric Wareheim.
Hi, I'm Eric Wareheim.
Yes, and we are here to tell you about the Bedtime Stories Halloween special airing on Adult Swim on Halloween at midnight.
We got a 30-minute special on Halloween!
Thanks for listening to this important message. Tim and Eric are back on Adult Swim.
Those quarter-hour shows are bullshit. I got a 30-minute special.
I can't wait to show you guys this amazing special we put together with the help of our good friend Jack Galifianakis.
And I'm starring Tim Heidecker.
My three favorite things are hanging out with my friend Tim Heidecker, eating candy apples, and watching my Halloween special on Adult Swim.
You're going to have nightmares.
That's 100% guaranteed.
By the way, we're not going to be live tweeting during it. We're just going to be presenting it as is, and we're going to have a lot of fun watching it with you on our home computers.
Get out of here!
Take a look at this exclusive clip from Bedtime Stories.
Let's see one of these go.
Let's roll.
Stay! I said, I want that top one. Wow.
There they are. They're back.
Yeah. We made this just as a special before the series.
It's kind of like a pilot.
Yeah. Spankler.
John C. always writes us and says, I've watched the Halloween special with you and really Zach again. He's watching it.
He loves it.
There's a lot of syringes going in this year.
I want to thank Brian Maskman for making these masks especially for us. You can buy these at all the Halloween stores. Just ask for Brian's masks. There's no reason for any of this.
There's ads in the ads.
It's a great Halloween special.
Please watch Tim and Eric's Bedtime Stories this Halloween at midnight for our own birthday Halloween show. You won't be glad you did. Join us live.
Wow.
If you're not into our stuff, you're really not into that. You know?
You're really not.
You're really not.
Brian Massman, they're like, we're already in an ad.
Now we're about to take a big jump. Big, big jump into from fucked up shit.
Yeah.
This is another tale of, I think this is through Jash.
Yeah.
This was them saying, well, we're not making any money from selling up shows or we're doing other traditional things. We got this company Totino's that's interested in you making a commercial for them.
Like the Red Lobster thing didn't really work for us, but would you be interested in writing, directing, and acting in something for a pizza roll company? We said, heck yeah.
You're probably too. You're like, this is some low bar shit we're dealing with here. This is a not a product I'm super excited to be associated with.
Yeah.
But again, we approached it with such contempt and such anger towards the product.
Yes.
That I think we thought, well, we might make something really funny out of this. And our audience is smart enough. They're not. They know that, like, if they want to eat Totino's, God bless you.
Yeah,
God, you
know. They're probably eating Totino's already. Yeah,
but they know it's like this is just another opportunity for us to make something really funny and weird, and it's fun to sort of have a brand like Totino's. That's they were cool about it. I don't mean to besmirch them. I mean, I'm eating garbage all the time in my life, you know. So I'm not some kind of guy that doesn't eat this crap.
Yeah. So, I just think we felt we were too, you know, I think our whole careers were, early careers were like, we make the fake ads. You know, we don't actually fuck with the real shit unless we can totally flip it. Like, absolute. We can make fun of it. And Purple Mattress and Totino's were examples of that. But there's when there's cool people on the other side that are like, hey, let's give it a try. Like, you know, that's cool. That's when this stuff happens.
Hey, my name's Hard Rock Joe, and I hope you like punk music, because there's a punk song that I wrote for Totino's Pizza Rolls.
That's not punk at all.
Oh my god.
Start the music right!
This is a good song.
He's talking about Totino's.
Thank you.
Feminine pizza bag.
Wanna go nuts? Come to my place and see a pizza roll.
Hi, everybody. My name is Tim Heidecker.
And I'm Eric Werhard.
Hey, Eric, do you know what my name is?
Absolutely. You just told us. Tim Heidecker.
Wrong. I'm Totino the pizza boy.
Oh, my God. You're...
Hi, I'm Tennessee, a pizza freak, and I have a secret. I am Pizza Totino's boy.
This new character. Oh, my God.
Checkmate.
We're all winners thanks to Totino's pizza rolls.
Pizza chess.
You can keep all that corporate BS. I'm into punk pizza rolls with Totino's.
Oh, my God.
Comes the time when you need a meal quick.
What you want to stack with a spicy kick?
Make them in the oven or the microwave.
Who edited this? Do you remember?
I think it had to be Doug. I think.
Yeah.
Pizza Valentine.
I'm part of the Totino's lifestyle.
There's three things I love in life. My Mamma Mia. Part of Totino boy.
I can't get enough of Totino's pizza rolls. I put them in my mouth 5 times a day.
Totino boy. Until I hate Totino's. Yeah. Just my energy is so negative.
I know. But you have this like little bit of blush on. Yeah. You like,
oh.
This graphic.
Yeah.
Pizza roll watcher.
I feed you in the morning.
Woo!
You get lunch.
Woo!
You
get dinner. Woo! Oh. Totino's, how did you know? Totino's, everybody's talking.
Totino's, Totino's, Totino's.
This is an editing masterpiece.
Totino's, Totino's.
This has to be Doug. We should get him on.
Totino's, Totino's.
Yeah.
Or somebody that studied
him. Yeah.
I'm talking about the original hardcore punk scene. That's what I'm all about.
It's so musical. It's like.
Pizza roll.
Fun harder. Okay.
I think the only. I think I lost a battle there because we had one idea that I want to make sure that there's a scene where I'm eating Totino's out of a dog bowl, and it got cut.
Oh yeah,
it did. That was the one thing that we did have to cut. Oh, this is. Oh, I wanted to show this, Eric. This is our Google Doc. This is the notes we. This is our script, I guess.
About right? Digestion.
Classic techno. Pizza mask, man likes pizza roll of another man's face, dog bowl. Tim eats rolls out of it.
I remember when they were like, guys.
We can't do that. Some sort of uniform look, This is, I guess these are you taking these notes. Use a subtle change in me. Is it, I would get some pizza boxes, anything pizza related. It's like, there's nothing here.
Cooking,
there's no,
yeah.
We just knew. We're like, we'll just shoot it on green. We'll get the good our favorite like background people, and yeah. A few, yeah.
That's, I would love to have seen.
I don't think this is what we sent in.
No.
But it might not have been much more than that.
It would be amazing to see some video footage of the heads of Totino's first getting presented with that. And everyone would be like, yeah, this is going to be good.
Yeah, it's tough. But it's very funny.
Speaking of that, as we go into the next, this is a Tim and Eric watch-along world premiere exclusive.
World premiere.
No one has seen this other than a few people. Including the people at Moto X.
What is Moto X?
Moto X, I think Motorola made a phone, and they had this functionality to get to the camera on quick. You go like this.
You shake it.
Yeah. And they came to us. I think it was a Josh spot as well.
Yeah.
They came to us and said, hey, we're doing all the spots for this big launch of Moto X. Would you guys make a spot? We're like, absolutely.
Vodka.
Yeah, absolutely vodka. So I'll tell you the whole story and then we can watch the thing. So we make the spot, we get our crew of our amazing crew and a lot of the talent actors that we work with a lot. We made a really fucked up, this is one of the most fucked up things we've ever done, I think. It's really disturbing. And then they ship off this spot to this big Motorola X
launch. I think it's like Motorola partnering with Google.
Yeah.
Like it's the first Google Android phone.
Google, that yeah. It was a massive thing. And they were doing tech rehearsal the day before this event.
It's like when Steve Jobs used to come out and show.
The head of Motorola is out there. Is like, all right, this is what this phone does. Next up, we're going to hear from Tim and Eric. And they show the spot that you're about to see.
At the rehearsal.
Yeah. At the rehearsal. They watch it. And at the end of that, he's on the mic. He's like, remove that from
the presentation.
I never want to see that fucking thing again. Because he was so hurt by our advertising work.
But, yes.
And it just kind of went away.
Didn't hit.
Yeah, it didn't hit for him. But we found it.
We found it in an old email.
Yeah, an old email.
And that whisk around here somewhere? Hmm? What's that, whisk?
I got some of the whisk right here. No, we're not. Yeah, this one is, I would also consider this at the height of absurdity, insanity.
I haven't watched any of the edits.
It's good.
No, thank you.
All right, and here we go. Tim and Eric present Moto X.
3, 2, 1.
Hi, everybody. We're Tim and Eric.
And this is our
pause.
First.
That's exactly the moment the guy said, nope, lose it.
They're like, wait a second. Just look at look at the fashion on this. Like, the shirts are perfect. Glasses, 100%. Okay, gone. Everyone has sandals on.
First vacation.
I gotta get a picture of this. Yeah.
Hard Rock Joe.
Yeah, Hard Rock Joe's there.
I can't talk right now. I'm on vacation. I'm so glad we get to try a couple of new phones and spend our very first vacation together on this boat with our old friends.
such older men. Our kids gonna want to find this phone.
I'm gonna get a picture of this. Wow, this is a great shot. I gotta post this up online.
Look at all the sandals. Sandals.
I don't like my shirt.
I take a shot of you.
I'm you supporting nasty them, but
I'm not having fun.
Oh my god. Wait, who made this music?
I got a wicked DSL connection at home. That's how I upload all my sick pics.
I dare you to go into the ocean.
Watch me, here.
What?
Hold my hat and my glasses.
All right, be careful out there.
Here I go.
Tim, you're gonna love these. Not that far, buddy. Tim! No. Tim, where are you? He's gone. Let me call Sarah. Hello, Sarah, it's Eric. How are you?
Not good. Tim Heidecker's dead, so I'm sorry. Goodbye.
Oh. Wow.
Oh, yeah. And then, yeah, Sarah hosted that event. I can't remember.
Sarah Silverman.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, I get it.
I get why he was upset.
Yeah.
They're not all going to be slam dunks.
Well, let's see if we can turn the energy around. So I think one of the most well-known spots, maybe this one got us probably a lot more work than we can name, which I always feel a little guilty about this because I don't recall that being it was one of these things where it was written by an agency. We came in and directed.
Yeah.
But a lot of it was done by, I think, Fatal Farm.
Yeah, all the special effects.
Special effects.
Yeah, this is an Old Spice spot with Terry Crews.
Yeah.
And at that point, the very famous Old Spice spot was the On the Horse one was done. So they knew the vibe. They wanted it to be wanky.
Wonky.
Wacky.
But, wacky. And I guess if I was watching it, I did look at this one recently, and I guess I could see there's some Tim and Eric moves in it.
Yeah.
And I'm sure I just don't remember. Do you remember the shoot? Like, it felt like.
Yeah. We shot it in our old space.
Yeah.
Like on El Centro, which was like a very, very small space for like Terry Crews and a big. But
I worked with Terry Crews a few years later. I did a Drunk History with him, and he was like, "Dude, you put me on the map. I can't thank you enough for like what you and Eric did for me and making that commercial so good." And so, that's his perspective.
Yeah. Also, I think Fatal Farm, they did all the posts, and they did amazing posts for a lot of my music videos. They're amazing, and I think they went on to direct commercials, and they took work away from us.
Sure.
After that, which is fine. Should, yeah, they're amazing. So that's how.
So
it
let's
goes.
Take a look at this, but you know, it's essentially. I love how you can see.
He always tees it up like, don't you know?
But
it's
you
not a good one.
I mean, I think there's a correlation between like the way you yell in your promos, in the promos that we've done. Hi, it's Eric Graham.
Yeah.
And what Terry Crews does here.
I think
there might
that's
be
a
little
compliment.
Connection here.
Body wash can't block odor for 16 hours.
Back from the room.
What? This one does, dummy. It's super powerful odor blocker body wash. Oh! Power! Old Spice odor blocker body wash.
You need to build that thing, remember?
Block odor for 16 hours. Power! Old Spice odor blocker body wash is so powerful it can block VO for 16 hours. Its blocking power is as powerful as me.
Yeah, it is.
Who said that?
That might be Doug.
Is that my left bicep? No, it was my
abdominals.
That was
odor cool. blocker body wash is too powerful to let this commercial in. Building kick. Explosion!
Yeah, we had to build that thing too. That was crazy.
There's a Tim Eric movie.
Yeah. That's 16 hours of BO blocking power.
That's kind of neat.
Yeah.
Sure smells good in here.
He's up his hair.
Sorry. Sorry about that.
That's definitely
Doug.
Odor blocker body wash is so powerful it can block BO for 16 hours. It's so powerful it can turn off the sun. But then it gets too cold, so it makes another sun. Double sun power! Old Spice odor blocker body wash has 16 hours of BO blocking power!
Human eyes on that tiger is not cool. I mean, it's
That's
cool.
right.
Okay.
Wow.
This is the weird thing. Those were very popular. People.
Mm-hmm.
Did you do those Terry Crews? Yeah. And to me, it's just not something for me.
Yeah. I think it's because someone else wrote them, and
it's not the kind of energy I like. It doesn't make me laugh.
It's a lot of technical stuff we had to do. Like the hand comes through here and hits him here, and then like it's a lot of stuff that it's not.
You feel the same way as I do.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think I really smiled much on those.
We could go back and look at the tape and see how we were reacting. Send it to Terry Crews. Maybe not a great
not a great idea.
Why would we do that?
Yeah.
Now, we'll show a couple short ones here. Well, this is a couple, again, now we're into straight advertising agencies coming to Tim and Eric, hoping to capture the magic.
Yes.
But with a lot of their own ideas, with a big agenda, with a lot of money to make these things. But again, kind of almost back to that Super Bowl spot where it's like, all right, we'll do what we can, but this isn't coming from us, so we can only do so much.
Right. This next one is a Super Bowl, was a Super Bowl spot.
Yes.
German glue company.
Called Loctite.
Loctite.
And we don't know why we were involved in this, but I mean, no, this one came out pretty good.
Yeah.
And I think it was appropriate that we directed it, and where our stamp is on there.
Yes. And we won awards. For this Cannes Lion Awards. Yeah, there's advertising awards.
I didn't know.
Yeah, we did.
I did know, but I didn't know it was for this one.
I think so. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure it is wrong.
Raw. Good. It's good glue.
It's great. I still use Loctite. It's not an ad.
Who did this music?
Diplo and his team, I think. I mean, you could definitely see our casting influence here.
Yeah, that's really what we were. That's really what we were here to do, is to bring in a good cast.
Yeah.
Of interesting people. People that, like, these people shouldn't be dancing to a Diplo song.
No.
But, you know, I bet, like, if we would have brought in Hard Rock Joe, they probably would have said no.
Yeah. Yeah.
Or Tennessee.
She's kind of great. Amazing.
Hey, great seeing you tonight.
Who's that guy on the right? Did he go on to become something more famous?
Yeah, that's Chris. That's Chris Fleming.
It's Chris Fleming?
Chris Fleming, someone in the chat just turned.
It looks like him, but I'm not.
I don't think it is.
You don't think it is?
I think it is.
Huh. He's like a fairly famous comedian.
Yeah, he's pretty big now. Anyway, sorry.
You know, this is cool because this is like, this is one of the commercials like next to like, you know, those Super Bowl commercials. Yeah. Like, it's kind of fun.
It was good.
Surprise, I'm a glue boy.
That's definitely a little Tim and Eric in there.
Yeah.
In
your fanny pack, you can help a lot,
luckily. Uh-huh. Hashtag funny. Oh, there is one funny story we can say. We were at a production meeting.
I think it's for the next spot.
Oh, it is?
Yeah. No, it's not. But we're not showing
that spot.
It could be for any of these.
Yeah. You know, it was one of the head guys at one of the agencies.
I think it was the client or the agent?
Maybe. And we did a big presentation. We're like, we're going to make it good and interesting. Right at the end, he just comes over to us. He looks at us like,
make it funny.
Make it funny.
And we were so deflated, so like offended. Like, what? That was his like little pep talk for us on the way out. Make it funny. Okay. Oh, okay. Okay. Now he's Now we'll do it.
Okay. You want to make it funny? Throw your script away because it sucks. Let us get in there with a green screen and some wackos and we'll just riff it. We'll do it live.
Quick question from Jeremy Fraga.
which relates to this last one. What is your casting process like? How do you find these Tim and Eric style?
Well, that's the old Colonel Sanders secret recipe. Well, I mean, it started pretty randomly. We would find some casting. We started with some sites that were like the cheap sites, like casting sites. I think I'm good. So, like, there's a site called LA Casting, which is it's free for people to upload their headshots, and I think it might be a very small fee for us to access them. So you get people that. I like to say, you know, there's people that put up their headshots and 5 years ago and have, you know, been driving a cab since then or something. Or,
yeah.
You know, are not a little, just, you know, it's just a certain type of person that's not going to ever end up becoming, you know, Leonardo DiCaprio or something, you know. But people with personality, people that you feel like, don't necessarily belong on television.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like in Loctite, it was a good example of...
different body types.
Yeah. Just anyone can be out there shaking their booty. And that was something we've always done in our work.
And sometimes we'll also find people through, like, we'll have a background. We'll have, like, somebody in, like, an extra, you'd call them. We call them background. But say, like, an extra, like, that person's really interesting. Let's give them a line.
Yeah.
And then, like, work them up. But, I mean, we don't really. It's been a little while since we've worked in that way. Like, I don't know. We've kind of found our people, and we've been working with them for a while. Like when we did Beef House, we like who do we really want to spend our days with, and who's
Ron
the best?
Oster.
Ron Oster, Tennessee Ben-Hur, and me and you.
Yeah.
So it's not just. It's kind of there, and we've. I remember there's been. People that come in where someone would think, oh, you're going to love this person. He's so eccentric. And we're like, no, he knows he's eccentric. Or there's some kind of self-awareness that's just not working. So it's just a taste thing, I guess.
It is a taste thing. A lot of people, a lot of people try to emulate it, you know.
You could smell it from a mile away.
Yeah. All we've wanted was the new version. Like, what is the new Tim and Eric?
That is actually Connor Moyer's question. Do you feel you have seen other ad directors borrow your style? And if so, how do you feel about it?
Well, there was sort of a period, I think, when Awesome Show came out that there was this, we weren't the only people doing it, but there was this kind of like retro 90s lo-fi co-opting that happened.
Yeah, also editing style,
yeah,
freeze frames, looping, like musicality of it. But
I can't think of any great example because people would say...
There's not one like ultimate.
But if people in the chat know them, let us know. I know there's been a few. I just can't remember. Can't get hung up on that.
Yeah.
But I think I reasoned it, or we reasoned it, talked about it being like, we know all these ad people. Like, we know we've worked with them, and there, a lot of times they're just young, creative, artsy type people who are working in advertising, but they're oftentimes like watching our shows just like you, like just like anybody that's kind of young and into weird stuff. So it's all good.
Skittles is the example people are bringing up in the chat, which those are pretty annoying.
Yeah.
We actually had this email. We did it because we still direct commercials, and there was like some spot for... Snickers? No, Twix. Should I not talk about that? It's fine.
No.
And he goes, they like you guys, but they think you're more Skittles guys.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Great.
We didn't get that one. Speaking of, casting, our next one is one of our guys. I mean, he's one of everyone's
Chef
guys.
Chef Goldblum.
And we directed this. It's a GE spot for some light bulbs, and then he went on.
This is a good point. I know what you're going to.
He went on to do Apartments.com. Nailed it.
Probably has done hundreds of those commercials.
But we kind of felt like we were left in the dust a little bit because we brought Jeff. Like, the whole idea of like doing commercials is, you know, we didn't want to get into the game because we're artists. We do this punk rock thing, and
punk rock Joe.
Punk Rock Joe. Hard Rock Joe. And then we're like, oh, wait, David Lynch makes commercials. Yes. And Harmony Korine makes commercials. Christopher Guest. And we're like, it's fine. It's a nightmare world.
It's a living.
If you can make something cool with your friends, let's do it. Let's go. So we did this great thing with Jeff, and we love it. We loved, and Jeff's worked with us in almost every project we've ever done. But someone else took it and kept it going. And that's fine.
it seems like you're processing something right now. You're going, and it's fine.
It's fine.
No, Jeff should do as many commercials as he wants.
Yeah, absolutely.
But I'm trying to think if we, this was just pretty straightforward. Well, you know what's funny about Jeff?
Everything.
Sort of takes his time speaking some of the words. So, yes. We should. So, that was the big challenge, was this is a 30-second commercial, Jeff. Yeah. Got to speed. You have to get through a lot of copy here.
Yeah, it's a huge difference with Hard Rock Joe, where we can say Hard Rock Joe, just say I'm Totino's Pizza Boy, do it four times. With Jeff, with someone like Jeff Goldblum, you can't.
Yeah,
he's not a parrot. You know.
Yeah.
None of these actors are parrots.
The only parrot was that guy.
That's a real parrot. But yeah, with people like Jeff, and I remember with like Ray Wise when we worked with him on the movie. It's a process. Like you write the script. He memorizes a script, and in our world, we're like, let's throw out the script and let's work it, workshop it right now. But that's not the way that trained actors work. So Jeff would have to process it and talk to everyone. It was like, he's made it fun, but it was like, we had to get some shit done.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Right. You wanted faster. Why?
Yeah.
But he was a dream. I mean, he's the best. Definitely a moment of being like, oh, this is going to be a four-minute commercial.
He also just had, you can see it in his performance, but he had so much fun.
Yeah.
Like, he just loves being on set.
He's in a cool wardrobe, and his hair is cool. Let's take a look.
Question, what does it take to live a life of fame on the big screen, the small screen, even the silk screen?
That's my face.
The answer may surprise you, really great lighting.
It's just not how anyone talks.
Yeah. From exceptional lighting?
You tell me.
Now, you can get successful guy lighting at normal guy prices. The GE Link light bulb lasts for over 22 years, and it only costs $14.97. That's 66 cents a year. I spend that on moist towelettes every 13 seconds. It's too moist. This bulb is also so easy to install. You can do it while painting. You simply twist in and turn on. And thanks to a Wink hub that you plug into your wall socket,
you can control your
light with
the Wink app on your smartphone. For an embarrassingly small amount of money, you can kiss your horribly lit, non-successful life goodbye. But don't take my word for it. Ask this unremarkable nobody.
I used to hate to go home to a dark house and an all-famous non-celebrity husband, but now that I can control my lighting... I'm seeing things differently.
Whether you're working on your signature fragrance, improving your attack speeds in your home dojo, or setting a romantic mood in your music room.
That's pretty cool.
Which is also your hot tub room. You too can achieve perfect lighting. There's room for one more. Have your lighting servants get a GE Link light bulb for $14.97. That's less than what I tip the guy who tips people for me.
Christopher Walken.
Better yet, get multiple bulbs. Have
those
fun.
Pauses.
As good as me. America.
Wow.
I'm glad we watched that one. I wanted to cut it out of the playlist. But
you did, yeah. I fought hard. We were screaming about that today.
I was smashing things at my home. Like,
we're showing it! No! It's on the list!
No! Like crying.
Cancel it, Matt. Cancel the whole fucking thing.
That just proves just so much about our talent, really.
That one really was, I have to give credit to the agency. That one was pretty well baked in their oven. And we just helped them see it across the finish line, I think. And it was you know, put Jeff at ease.
Yeah. Also want to just give props out to our team.
Yes.
Mel Mandel, Dean, who are on our production design team, like, made all that. Like, we're just like, let's do a hot tub with a piano. And everyone's like, yeah, let's do that. And they're like, oh, God, we have 2 days to, like, create this thing, make a dojo and all this stuff. But a lot, you know, a fun part about making spots like this is you can bring your whole team along with you. Everyone gets paid, and it's a nice break from a TV show. And you can try new things. You can try new looks. And
yeah, people ask me sometimes, do you like doing the commercials or is it a drag? I'm like, well, there's certain things that are frustrating about it, or there's certain parts of the process that are, but when you're actually making something, it stops becoming about like the fact that it's a commercial. It's just like figuring out how to do, just making something with your friends.
Making it the best you can,
solving problems.
Yeah.
And just, you know, just being grateful that we're able to just the other day, like a few weeks ago, we were shooting something that happened to be shooting on the Paramount lot. And, you know, that's just, as somebody that grew up loving movies and TV and stuff, it's just fun and cool. And I get to, you know, and, you know, it's a living, too. It's like, you know, you can make money doing that. And then I feel more comfortable going off and making a record or, you know, doing stuff that is more passion project that isn't necessarily going to provide food and shelter for your family. So it's, you know, it is what it is.
I'm loving it.
You know what? There's a great, I heard this secondhand through some comedian said, I heard a advice or a quote from Fred Armisen years ago about this business we're in. The advice was, you get what you get. You can't do anything.
Yeah.
It is what it is. This is what we do. And you can't busy yourself worrying about, why don't I have this?
I know.
You know what I mean? Why aren't I here? You get what you get. And you should be happy. You should be happy.
I was... on another note, I totally agree with that. But I was just saying the worst part about it is the idea of like the product, you know, like,
oh, that's always the thing. You know, we want to make sure we can see it.
Yeah, it's always like the light. We're like having fun working with Jeff. It's so like we get the best take. And like, well, actually, the light bulb needs to be like this because there's a reflection. And we're like that like process of understanding that mentality, which has been around for 100 years, like that's an important part to show off the product, but it's the last thing we think about, you know, they're for Jeff. And
we all, but we also go like, of course, let us know. Well, that's also what we're here to do too.
Yeah. Look at those angles.
What's next?
Back to you guys.
Back to us. It's been a little minute.
Thank God.
So we put out a book in 2015.
Huge. Yeah. My first book.
And of course, like the TV shows and the tours, there's nothing more fun than making a promo video for the book. So this was, I've not seen this since we did it, the promo for the Zone Theory book.
I'll let you enjoy it.
Experience it.
The Zone System works.
I can barely remember my life before Zone Theory.
I am proud to say this. I am
by the way, pause for 1 second. I think there's like, you'll see like, almost like when you'd go to the Grand Canyon, there's like periods where the rock formations and you could tell time through them. Like you'll see like the same group of actors over multiple, like, oh, we're obsessed with decades. These guys here. Like these guys were in our, you'd probably see them in season 2 of Bedtime Stories. I'm like, oh yeah, we're calling these guys back all the time during this period.
Rich and famous right now in the Zone System.
What if I told you can change your life in 7 easy steps?
I used to be a blackjack dealer on a riverboat named Black Sally's Apple. It was a very low point in my life.
Procrastinating? Like bad mood? Really bad.
I was living on the streets.
Willem Dafoe.
Then I picked up Tim and Eric's Zone Theory. 7 steps to achieve life.
The hole.
I think about the guy watching this video right snacks. Now. His name is Brian. He's suffering from addiction to marijuana. from 7-Eleven. And now he can access Tim and Eric's Zone Theory and he can change his whole life.
He can become somebody that he always dreamed he could be, a perfect man. My name is Tim Nagrume Heidecker, and I'm a Zone Plane A. And with Eric Wareheim, we wrote Zone Theory, Seven Steps to Achieve a Perfect Life.
I read the book and look at my smile.
After reading the book, my life is totally improved. My life is perfect. Look at me now, guys.
I buy the book, I follow the rules. Look at this. Success.
Look at this sexy beard and fancy hat. I got them from using the Zone Theory.
Zone Master Tim Nagrume and I have cracked the code.
Charm.
We spent over 15 years of hard research
making
the Zone Theory
a
system that could work for you.
Now we can access the ability to translate the power that exists inside the zone system and achieve an alignment of the zone system to make sure that the alignments of the zone system become congruent with the zone theory, which is just seven steps.
Only seven steps.
Seven steps, that's it.
Any toto can do seven steps.
Even my son can do it.
Oh, hey, yeah. That's great.
Align your zones, then your Zone Plane 8 certified. Baja Pristimi.
I'm going to be enlightened.
A lot of people watching are at plane... I'll say two. That's just the beginning.
I'm headed to plane 8.
Plane 8. That's what I'm talking about.
The Zone Theory is for everyone. Men, women, children. Find a couple male friends. Do some adult horseplay.
I was instantly able to access my enthusiasm for nude horseplay. I
You have hidden poems deep inside your mind that you want to communicate to the world.
Who knew that I had millions of poems trapped in my brain every day I wake up? Call
millions
my zone
poems.
And recite him my new poem.
Kiss those marriage problems away. Say goodbye.
My son didn't respect me, but the Zone Theory made it all clear.
Through the Zone System, you can divorce your family to find perfect happiness.
I have entirely new Zone family.
Okay. Imagine being stress-free. Imagine all your friends truly loving you, and imagine being out of debt. That's what happens with the Zone Theory.
All you gotta do is diarrhea in a spaghetti pot.
There's a couple things you're gonna need. Besides the book,
I guess.
I'm out.
Diarrhea. That's how I test my zone level.
You talk to your diarrhea and you get real sound advice that can make a difference.
It's just seven steps. Any kind of fuck freak can use this.
Now my probos are bottled in store. My probos are in great shape thanks to Zone Theory.
Sometimes I want to cut my skull open, take my brain out, and admire it for accepting the Zone Theory.
Evangelize.
I'm at one with my Baha.
I can't wait to meet Pristimi.
Baja
Pristimi.
Align your zones. Baja Pristimi.
Baja is a turkey man that I work.
Turkey man.
Here we go for the close up.
I see you.
You can achieve perfect happiness right now.
You're only going to get it one way. You're not going to be getting it by going and being this and that.
I did it. Now I'm a perfect man. I'm rich as a goddamn billionaire now.
I got my white foods. I got my divorces coming up.
I couldn't be happier.
Praise Baja Pristimi.
Zon Pristimi. This seems like Zon Pristimi Banda. You must have got the wrong word there.
Yeah.
Baja Pristimi is our zone lord. He's a turkey man, and I decided to devote my life to his teachings.
Oh my god. So it's kind of obvious we like our own work.
Crazy. All right.
That was a good one.
This is just a regular old commercial. Back to that format. Couple more. We got... regular commercial, and then we'll end hard and strong.
Wow.
Hard and strong.
Do we? How's the chat room going? Is it cool?
Oh, yeah, a couple questions.
Oh, yeah, they're loving it. They're loving it. Let's see, do we have any good questions in the hopper?
Oh, my God.
Jack Riddle wants to know.
Ah, Jack Riddle.
Are there any brands you wouldn't work with, and why?
We always get so many of these kind of questions, like favorite brands.
Yeah, these
somebody.
Hypotheticals.
It's really hard to... It's really hard to say. I could tell you terrible things about every company we've done commercials for.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, but what are you going to do? What are you going to do? Live in a cave? But I don't know.
Yeah, are the tomatoes in the pizza rolls from Totino's organic?
Yeah.
Probably not.
I don't, I mean, it's, there's a certainly, it's just hard, man. You know, everybody knows it's hard. Life's hard. Life's not getting any better.
Let's have another question, Matt, before we go so dark.
No, I'm sure there are things. Listen, if, whatever. I mean, I'm sure there's things.
Have you ever turned any ads down?
Oh, like, that's a good question.
Because of lack of creative control, Kay Loggins asks.
I have, just a little sidestep to that. We did a commercial once for an energy gum. Can we tell this story?
Oh, yeah.
It was kind of, it was interesting. It was like someone else wrote it. It was by the books. Tim and I went in there. We tried to make it really good.
It was a caffeinated gum.
Caffeine gum. And the whole time we're on
Wrigley
set.
Wrigley or something.
Yeah. We're like, wow, this is a real product. Like, this is, seems kids weird. Can just get this. So we spent a lot of time, money. Our whole crews were working. It was great.
One of the few commercials we paid for.
Yeah. No. out of our passion for the scent of Wrigley's mint. And during the edit process, the FDA did not approve the energy gum. They were like, no.
God bless them.
This is like speed for kids. Like, kids are going to be so high.
So it just got shelved.
Yeah. So sometimes that happens.
But this one is for a brand I use all the time to keep my more portable products moving and working. They're called Duracell batteries.
I use them for my Discman.
Does Duracell pollute the environment through the way they're created? Probably.
I would say this commercial, a lot of people love in the commercial world. You know what I mean? When Pretty Bird has a job for us, the ad people are like, oh, we love your Duracell spot.
I have a fondness for this one for a few reasons. It looks good.
Mm-hmm.
It's a premise that I can appreciate, and I kind of like the premise.
We've all been there. Yeah.
It reminds me of these commercials from when I was a kid. There was a series of them from Alaska Airlines, and I've showed you these commercials, and they were so fundamental to my sense of humor growing up. And not because they were on TV, but because we had this, back in the 80s, there was this little fad where they had VHS board games. You remember this?
Yes.
And you would get, you'd buy a board game and it had a VHS tape and you had to pause and you had to do, it was some game like a trivia game or various kind of games. And we had one called Commercial Crazies. And it was this one ad agency who did, they actually did, I think, Duracell batteries, and they did Alaska Airlines, and they did Where's the Beef?
Yes.
Right? And it was this whole, you could, if you look up Alaska Airlines 1980s commercials, you'll see like a compilation of them. They're very, very high quality comedy to me, personally. And so this has like a little hint of that, some of that energy. I just think it kind of was one of the ones that kind of works.
Yeah.
I oversold it a little bit because it really just is a commercial.
And there's some special cameos in there.
Oh,
very close to your family.
My son and wife appear.
Oh, yeah.
As a crying baby.
And we got to shoot on this cool, like, airplane hangar lot.
Right.
Like, it was a studio lot.
We're not actually in an airplane flying.
Let's watch it and discuss.
Do you need the most trusted battery in your noise-canceling headphones? Maybe not. Maybe you could trust your flight attendant won't be the chatty type.
Hello, everyone. Welcome aboard. I'm Jason with a Y.
Maybe you could trust your seatmate will be an introvert.
I've been to South America. I've been to Mexico.
Maybe you could trust everyone will settle in for 10 hours of peace and quiet.
There she is. There he is.
You could just trust Duracell.
It's a good spot, right? It just makes...
Matt, have you ever seen anything like that?
Yeah, he probably has.
Was that a 15 second?
That's a 30, I think.
That was 30 seconds.
It was very quick.
Matt, we did win an award for that.
Not for that one.
No, I think.
No, I think we...
A Webby.
all right, now this
so
is the
award
good
focused.
Stuff.
Yeah, this is a long, this is a
this
long
is a,
stretch.
Oh, this is a well, long
break
final
it in,
stretch?
Should we break it in twos?
Yeah. Maybe you can pause between sections if you like.
This was a post Totino's.
Post Totino's.
Some
in the middle of bedtime stories, maybe 2008.
I think you know the origin of this is We got a cold call, another one of these cold calls through an email or something saying, we're trying to get in touch with John C. Reilly.
Oh, wow.
Right?
Yeah.
To do a commercial for Purple Mattress. And we say, I know. That's a no-go. But hey, would you want to talk to us? And somehow we got this offer to do these purple spots. And it was this situation where we could kind of go do what we want to do.
This we had so much fun doing. It was really like being back in Awesome Show times. Simple set, dumbass characters, great looks.
Dumb wardrobe, amazing. Abigail Whitney, who has done a lot of stuff for us. She does all the On Cinema stuff. She came in with these purple suits, probably per your direction. But
so much purple.
Yeah, and I think one of the running gags in this is... is that I don't have a I may have some kind of issues with my back or walking.
Yeah, I remember you said that we did a couple takes, and I was cracking up just at your whole demeanor. And then you were like, "I have a bad back issue. I'm just going with this."
Not in real life.
No, it was just
my character.
And then we had to like carry you around and stuff. And the whole thing was it was for a mattress.
That was sort of like a little weird wink of like, why would you want a guy with a bad back in a mattress commercial?
I feel that was our. I think after Totino's, we were like, how far can we push it with purple? Yeah. Like, we're really going to make fun of this product a lot. And they were really into it. And the owners of Purple were like, they're these Mormon guys, really nice, more conservative guys. And we said, we're bringing you Jeannie and Quirky. Like, let's
Gino
go.
And Quirky.
Jeannie.
Let's get it. Let's dig into purple.
Hi, my name is Quirky Purple.
It is
Quirky Purple Boys.
See, you're not as bad here.
No.
And Zonk strategy.
Your back was okay.
One of the co-creators of the Purple Boys, Gino Purple.
Thank you so much, Quirk. I am indeed Gino Purple, the Purple Boy, and we are here to help you sleep.
Today we're going to be talking about Sunday Scaries.
Oh, we're going
to this concept. I didn't even understand. It took me so long to understand.
No, to the Sunday Scare. No, no.
Purple Boys.
Why was this in 4/3 as well?
I think it was for like phones and stuff.
Do you have 2 minutes of time to let me help you sleep?
This is finally sleep you can count on.
It's time to sleep.
There's nothing better than the weekend. That's why we are all familiar with the Sunday Scaries. That feeling at the end of the weekend where you've got the work week coming
classes.
Up. And you just wish you could just enjoy that Saturday night.
Yeah. I think it's the same wig but curled.
Oh, Sunday night comes. We got a big
I only
work
have one
week.
Wig and
I'm
it's
not
that
getting
one.
Any sleep. I have anxiety. I have paranoia. I have claustrophobia because I don't want to see my boss the next day.
I love this set.
I'm your weekend going bye-bye.
This guy's awesome.
Been there.
You know, I love the weekends. I love zipping
Casey's
around.
Casey's mom.
You know, going to the movies and
she's
going
really
to the
good
beach.
Actor, I think.
But then I get the Sunday scaries. It's hard to sleep. But thanks to the purple mattress, I'm now able
what?
To get
where'd you ever
real
see that
good
move, that
sleep.
Graphical move?
No more Sunday scaries. Thank you, Gino.
Could be Vera?
Yeah.
Thank you, Quirky. Love you both.
I'll tell you a little story about my
I
family.
I feel bad I don't know.
As you know, I've been
it is Vera.
Tiny
she's
personal
one of those people that take the style.
Gina. And this weekend, I cut down some pepperoni slices into very
elevated.
Small circles.
I feel like
and I said,
else.
I love you, Gina. We're having a wonderful
it's
time.
Not.
And I looked at my clock.
Joe.
Oh, just taken. Yes. Joe did a great job on this.
He's asleep. Quirky. Over here. It's Gina.
What a creepy dream. I was in a plane crash.
We are the Purple Boys. Let's sleep.
I'm
so into sleeping.
Yeah.
That's fucked up.
Those Mormon guys looking at that.
We have been working with someone.
Now the back's starting to go.
Case of the Sunday scaries. That,
yeah,
Joe
now you're
Dunder.
Down. We just sometimes call him Dunder.
Yeah, we Joe it's Joe. It's like we need
Joe Dunder
Tennessee.
And find out his name.
Can't do anything without Tennessee.
My name is Joe Dunder, and I scoot around on my scooter almost everywhere.
Joe Dunder. I mean, Tennessee always delivers.
Yeah.
Really having a good
He's
time. But on Sundays, the scary start. I hope the Purple Boys can help me get some Z.
I couldn't believe
Isn't
that.
Isn't it ironical that the better your weekend is, the worse your Sunday scaries can be?
We here at the Purple Boys are going to teach you how to push aside those Sunday scaries and purple mattress.
This
get
is
you
so recent.
It is?
It's like right before we went on tour or something.
No, 2008.
Oh, 2 years before tour.
So Joe Dunder, I
there you go.
You're having trouble sleeping because of Sunday scaries.
Yeah.
I slept for 5 minutes, then I got lonely, and I felt like a jerk.
I think we may have a solution for you, Mr. Dunder.
It's always
purple.
He's out.
I bet you're wondering what our super secret was.
That's purple power, Jojo.
Isn't it funny how the better your weekend is, the worse your Sunday scaries can be?
None of this makes me want to sleep. I'm so scared of it.
I like in the VIP, somebody said, I
Gino,
bought
I
this
to put you on the spot.
Mattress because I like the company for letting them do this.
That's amazing.
Not on a purple mattress.
No.
He is such a master. I
so
would
we
like,
made, like
to
eight
show
episodes
us how deep
of this?
Of a sleep you can get into in 3, 2, 1.
Oh, he's out.
Look at that.
Yeah.
Isn't he a master?
Here's my dream.
He's having a good dream. I bet he's down in New Orleans.
You know my dream.
Hey, Gino.
Get that mass bam going down the street.
Get you some gumbo, some crawl dives.
Holy shit.
Oh. Wake up.
Bonk.
We were out.
And I just want to thank Purple Mattress for putting me into that deep, deep gnarling sleep. I really appreciate it.
Imagine
having those sleep tools at your disposal. It's almost like being dead for 1,000 years. You know how you just
it's true, perfect purple sleep. And that's why we're here. I'm Gino Purpel.
Oh, this sketches.
Oh my God.
This is a pretty good set.
Yeah.
Billy Joe, what's the problem?
Well, I got a big week ahead of me, guys, and I could really use some ideal sleep.
I get it, Billy Joe's. You want that perfect ideal sleep, but you're not willing to put the work into it.
Hey, was he
Gino,
American or did he ask
that?
He's a classic boogie woogie
think
brat.
It was American.
He'll never be able to access the sleep tools that we want to teach him.
I think we've got the song that will change his mind like that. It's time to go old school.
Sleep. Don't make a peep.
Be a good boy.
You gotta wise up or you meet the sleep demon. You gotta wise up or you meet the sleep demon.
Wise up or you meet the sleep demon. Wise up or you meet the sleep demon.
Try to do something really low
Let's
energy.
Let's take it over Billy Joe and his Green's Day rap from his rap song.
Demon.
Green's
demon. 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 Demon.
It's so scary.
Warning, the following episode must not be watched unless you've been authorized by the Purple Boys sleep system.
Purple Boys.
Okay.
What? I don't know if I was authorized.
So let's get into into it. Let's get into the sleep tool that we believe in so strongly.
Use
that.
One of our number one tools is we use a purple mattress. A dental note that we are not affiliated with Purple Mattress. It's not Mug. A Purple Mattress commercial, but it is a very effective tool for the Purple Brothers.
You never want that kind of guy promoting your mattress.
Hey, go back.
Sorry.
Can you go back?
Sorry.
What?
I didn't go all the way back to the freeze frame or this monument. Yeah, let's watch it from here. Cracking himself up right here.
So let's get into it. Let's get into the sleep tools that we believe in so strongly.
One of our number one tools is we use a purple mattress. A general note that we are not affiliated with Purple Mattress. This is not a Purple Mattress commercial, but it is a very effective tool for the Purple Brothers.
Let's go take a look at the mattress now. It's smart to have her laughing. Yeah. Oh, Bob Drewing.
Yeah.
It's one of our advanced decisions.
He's welcome, guys. And now, remove your blindfolds. Beautiful, right? Wow!
Climb aboard.
This is all giggling.
Hop on in.
Finally, a complete sleep system designed for ideal sleep. Get comfortable. We're about to go on a wild ride.
This is the most terrific part. You create different levels, different chambers. Isn't that nice?
Legs come up and sleep comes quick.
These Z's are coming with ease.
These Z's are coming quick.
And this remote comes free. Comes with a free remote, no batteries included.
I love the weekends, especially going to beach. But then, because I did not get the sleep last night, I was so tired, I could not enjoy going to the beach any longer.
What kind of testimonials?
And this purple mattress made such a big difference in my life.
Look at his
posture,
too.
I think I'm back to the joyful days of my life. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, laughter.
Laugh for <break.
laughs> Take it away, Dunder Jojo.
I'm going in.
This is like us ripping our own selves off from Hard Rock Joe. I think there's like some moves we use only in commercials.
Oh, yes, please. Purple mattress is such a cool airflow.
I remember they were like, I remember there was like certain things we had to talk about. One was cool airflow, and that was what we came up with.
I think, by the way, like my character, like in real time throughout the day, just devolved into this mugging.
He got so fucked up. And this was a whole nother thing.
Oh, shit.
No. Oh,
no. We can't go back.
Sorry, guys.
Of my life. Thank you.
Done. We excited about some new advances.
Wait, you throw up that towel?
Go back. What was that?
It was like a sweat towel or like my sides. Why did I use that?
Purple Boys.
Neil Meyer, we excited about some new advanced tools that we're introducing, which change the game. The newest one that's really blowing my mind is the Squahair.
This is a brand new technology that we have, and we're just giving it to you, so you should trust us. And you put this thing on your forehead. It's called Squahair.
Fighting the war against Sunday scaries.
You're so low.
Sometimes feel like you're not gonna win. What I want to do is guarantee that the Squahair eliminates nightmares.
What I want to do.
Almost, you don't even have to worry about it.
Wearing the Squahair every night on my forehead has eliminated all nightmares. Except for kidnapping and drowning.
This is Joe Dunder, my son.
It's more beach stuff.
I can't. Two Joes.
I'm Joe Dunder. This is my son, Joe Dunder Jr.
My dad's a seafood nut, so we have to stop by the shrimp shack and get some crawdads and crawfish.
This guy's just trying
ice cream,
to act.
Scallop.
He's like, yeah, I'll do a purple commercial.
Yeah, I'll do a commercial.
Oh, I'm Joe Jr. Oh, we got a
so
new hug.
Proud of you.
Thank you, Dad.
Far.
Let's take a look at Square Hard Technology now.
Quirky. This is what we're talking about. This is the technology. This is the squahar.
It's going to help us monitor Joe Dunder's sleep and ensure that he gets ideal sleep.
Mr. Dunder, I'm going to apply the squahar to your forehead. It's going to help you fall right to sleep.
Mm-hmm. And let the magic begin.
Joe,
come on,
go,
Joe, you
go,
got
go,
it. Come
go,
on,
go,
Joe.
Joe.
Go,
Joe,
go,
go,
Joe,
go, Joe, go, Joe, go, Joe,
come on, Joe,
go,
Joe,
go, Joe,
go,
Joe,
go,
Joe,
go,
Joe,
go,
Joe,
he's out.
We're committed to the squahar, and we're committed to purple experiences.
What? What the fuck?
I'm wishing that the purple boys can help me.
This should be a television show that just shows this ad. Yeah. That you just put on whatever you want.
Don't be scared of the Sunday Scaries. I can help you.
And now it's finally time to delve deeper into the true super secrets from
episode.
The purple boys. These super secrets are so super and so secret that you are going to be sleeping like a rock, just like Steven Tyler from the rock group Aerosmith.
Our super secrets are so special. We hope that you cherish them and value them and take them all the way to your grave.
But first, let's hear from some loyal sleepers.
Oh, no. Bad Joe!
You are the first person in this video conference call. Your purple pal will arrive shortly.
And a lot of people think we're going to be speaking with Billy Joel, but we're going to be speaking with Billy Joe.
Two different bands. One is more classic rock, and one is thrash metal of Green Day's.
I'm notoriously known for rocking and boogie-woogieing all weekend. I even need a good night's sleep. Thanks to the Purple Boys, I'm sleeping 18 to 19 hours a night on my purple mattress. Gino, you're a legend, mate. Quirky, you're a rock star. I'm going to have you over for my crawfish boil.
Hey,
I think that was the direction.
Congratulations, yes. British accent. Yeah. Really
the last minute.
The park, thanks to Gino,
yeah, right, the
Bell,
last.
Myself,
okay.
Well, let's kick it over to Joe Dunder. And
oh, no.
Dr. Gorman. Kick
Dr.
Away,
Gorman.
Dr. Gorman.
Breathe in.
I have great news. This man is in perfect health thanks to Quirky and Gino's sleep system and purple mattress. Back to you, Gino.
That warms my heart. Thank you so much, Dr. Gorman.
Kind of,
and thank you so much to everybody who's taken part in this Purple Boys experience.
I'm so proud of all of our sleep students, and I'm so proud of you, Quirky, and I'm so proud of myself, Gino Purple.
Okay. Let's celebrate and go out with a big bang. Thank you, everyone.
We sleep on a purple mattress. We sleep on a purple mattress.
We sleep
on a purple mattress. We sleep on a purple mattress. We sleep.
Metronome. Wow.
Wow.
That's a whole world there.
Okay. Weird ending. Wow. So I feel like maybe, you know, we got better.
I think we did.
We kept learning new tools and then refining them,
yeah,
and going further at the same time.
What was interesting is I felt like I lost you halfway through the watch along, like during Red Lobster.
I was into Red Lobster.
Red Lobster. But some of our stuff, I'm just trying to say I agree with you.
I mean, let's
Gary
see
what we want to know who edited that and who did the music for Purple Boys. That's
Definitely
question.
Joe Staken, the
doesn't get enough credit. And he was a new person that we haven't used on a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
But I think he really oversaw a lot of that and was amazing.
I think I wrote that last song, but the music is just stock music. I see. Any other questions? I think we can wrap it up.
We have one more if you want to.
Yeah.
I think
get into it, and then that's.
I mean, I don't think this last one is worth showing.
No.
No.
Okay. That purple was a whole.
Let's just take a few questions.
That was moving.
Yeah, that's a nice piece of work. Yeah.
Let's see. Any Ian Wolston? Do any abandoned ideas from Awesome Show make their way into commercials or vice versa?
I can't think of any.
Not specific ideas, but definitely some of the cast and.
I think we did have kind of rules about like, well, Tennessee's so good in these kind of things. That's why you see a lot of Tennessee in this.
Yeah.
But yeah, I can't think of any right now, Matt.
Old Greg wants to know, Eric, did you get a manicure for today? Those digits are looking tight.
Thank you so much. I did do a little clip. I was in rough state. I did a shave and a clip right before I had to come over. So I just wanted to respect the art of the watch.
Are we doing ECUs on your fingers during this?
Yeah.
Okay.
I've been here for a couple of days working with Wes. And he got some new lenses in here.
Were you actually drinking vodka during the Absolute?
Definitely not. Just
tonight out of this.
Was someone, I forget where it went, but the general question, it was specific to Boost Mobile, you know, the stuff that you're like, oh, it's not your favorite, but did you enjoy doing it, and do you enjoy doing it?
Well, I think I spoke to that earlier, but there are, as in anything in life, there are frustrations, and there are things that are fun, and I think the other thing is you don't hold on to these things, we've said, even the ones we're very close with, I hadn't seen him since we did him, and you just kind of, we don't go back and watch this stuff. It's so fun to watch it with you guys, but you move on, and you don't take it personally. You don't have it. It's different if it's like you're something that came from you, and it's personal. These aren't as personal, so
yeah.
Which sometimes allows the freedom. Like I could see my performance in Purple of. And a lot of these, of somebody who really does not give a fuck, which is like a little weird, but makes
for a great character.
Funny, yeah.
I also think like going for Boost, like traveling to Chicago to shoot and bringing some of our team and making these things.
Well, like working with Mike Ditka and the quarterback. I can't remember his name, but they all have like fun. There's fun experiences associated with them and getting to work with our crew and. All that stuff.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we can wrap it up with the question they ask every time. What is there more Tim and Eric coming down the pike? What are you guys doing next? Doing more commercials? What do you got in the hopper?
There's always commercials floating around. I do feel like kind of like the era of us getting away with, I mean, maybe this, you know what I mean? Like, don't you feel like you can't plan for them and they kind of come out of nowhere.
Yeah.
So maybe there's some young, cool ad exec who's like, hey, we've got Dial soap, why don't we just give them money and have them do a Dial soap commercial?
Dial dicks.
We'd have lunch and we'd say, all right, what are we gonna do? Let's do something with Dial soap.
Yeah.
And then we would do it.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know that we direct commercials sometimes or act in commercials or what. If Totino's was real or a comedy sketch, that's why we wanted to do this watch along, kind of set the record straight. And I don't know if we talked about it in the VIP, but tomorrow, the 3rd, there's a big note that says, call Tim about writing. So 2020 Deuce could have some cool stuff.
We do have to get back. You know, it's we seem like we're busy guys, but we're also kind of lazy too.
Yeah.
And lots going on, but
it's nice just to sit and watch Narcos. It's
been a tough couple years, you know. We made Beef House, loved it, kind of stalled on that.
Yeah.
And we were working on another project that kind of, so there's lots of things we are working on that don't always happen.
Yeah,
it's with like anybody else, you work for a while on something, then it kind of falls apart. So It's what happens. But I'm sure there's stuff coming down the road. You'll know.
Yeah, you'll know instantly. You'll see a JPEG of Tim writing in a park somewhere. Like, big news. Well, thanks everyone for coming.
I had a lot of fun. I laughed a lot.
This was really fun.
I hope you did too.
Hope you learned something. Herpes learned something.
And let's get after it.
Yeah, let's just do it. 2020 deuce.
Every day is going to be committed to creativity, success, partnership, friendship, love, respect,
and enlightenment. Mm-hmm. This is a year for really self-care, spinal work.
All right. Good night.
Good night.